first quarter, and if anything, a slight breeze at their backs.
But hardly any breeze to speak of. Umpire Soares gets the game underway. 42 is Honeybun for Richmond. Eagles moving forward out of the centre bounce. McKenna gets the hand pass across to Turley. High kick towards half forward flank. Almost McKenna of Richmond. McKellar, rather, picked up by Lewis up towards the goal square. Which way will this go? Oh, off the ground and still in the field of play. Sumich caught by Weightman. Weightman kept the ball in. I think Richmond would be very happy to see it out. That was a danger in the first 30 seconds.
Well, they really did have a good chance to score a goal off the ground there, but courageous play there by Weightman just after that little incident. There's Honeybun, who's been in great form. He gets it down to the ground, and he went again after it. Now, the umpire's found a free kick. It'll go Richmond's way to the champion captain, Dale Weightman. Now, he's transferring play across the face of goal. Out wide is Allan McKellar. Those haircut of a couple of weeks now, he's been really short back and side, but the umpire not allowing here. The Richmond supporters saying that he should have allowed the play on decision there as Brian Lees brings it towards half forward.
Players set themselves on. That's a nice mark by Guy McKenna, who is one of the best defenders in league football.
McKenna goes with the hand pass to Rance, the skipper. His kick up towards half forward. Nobody there for the Eagles. There wasn't an Eagle within
20 metres of that, but they might have a chance to get back. Honeybun fumbles, gets it to McKellar. Off to free, pops the hand pass over the top. Thompson, McKellar. Good tackle by McKenna. Here's Rance near the boundary line. A backhander to Turner. Caught high by Thompson. No whistle. Now the whistle goes, and the umpire says there was a throw in that, and it's a Richmond free kick to come to Michael Thompson.
Far too much use of the handball there by Richmond. They've obviously been used to run and run in numbers, but they overdid that handball by just about three too many.
Michael Thompson to half forward, lovely lead. That is by Geoff Hogg. He's kept well down to one goal last week, but he's a very good full forward. Up towards the forward line. Over the back is Phil Scott. Now they've got open space everywhere for the Eagles, and Chris Mainwaring can run 50 metres if he likes. One bounce, then he elects to kick it right down towards half forward. Players set themselves for the mark, and a good strong mark down there in defence for Richmond by Paul Morris. This is his second game of league football. That's Peter Wilson, former Western Australian, getting it up towards centre wing. Dwayne Lamb takes it away and brings a short one in towards half forward, and the mark has been taken there by Chris Waterman.
Waterman, centre of the ground, inside half forward. Lead by Jackson, and he's got it 45 metres from goal. Well, young Stephen Jackson, who's kicked 8 goals in his first 2 games of VFL football, great debut against the Bears at Carrara with 6 in his first match, just 19 years of age. See how he goes for the Eagles' first goal. In fact, the first goal of the match. Quite a long run up at this one. Kicks from about 48 metres. Pretty close. Just offline, a minor score.
There he is, Stephen Jackson. Laffey, Michael Laffey picking him up. 1 point to the West Coast Eagles. The kick comes out wide towards halfback Michael Pickering against Mainwaring. Now Pickering's very strong overhead. Covers a lot of territory. Transfers play to centre wing. Or still actually towards the halfback area is Phil Egan. Egan, exciting type of player. Guy McKenna sets himself, taps it away to centre wing. Dean Turner, a quick kick, goes straight to McKellar. McKellar to Lambert, who's been in sensational form in recent weeks. There's Lambert, over to Knights. Knights at half forward to Egan. Egan, another hand pass. Back it comes to Bauer. He's caught, some good tackling going on there. Now Knights goes in, and Pike, and straight over the top of the ball. Knights gets it to Weightman. Weightman playing for the free kick. Gets it back to Knights. Back to McKellar. Oh, it's going nowhere, the ball at the moment, as Bauer grabs it, brings it to half forward. The mark has been taken by Phil Egan.
Well, that was remarkable. There must have been 12 to 15 hand passes before there was a kick.
There's far too much use of the handball by this young Richmond side. I think Kevin Bartlett's trying to get some system in and get the handball and the players running, but they're just running themselves into trouble by having one or two too many hand passes.
Well, this is Phil Egan. He's normally a great kick for goal. He's played a number of games, in fact, for Richmond at full forward and kicked big bags of goals. Now, he's only 35 to 40 metres out directly in front and a chance to score the first goal of the game. The Eagles at the moment on One behind, Richmond yet to score. Phil Egan from directly in front lays back on that one, hooks it across his body and is well offline, and through it goes for a point. So that's 1 point apiece.
Brennan to kick in for the Eagles, going towards the outer side. And the lead is on from Worsfold, marks at half-back flank. His kick up short of the wing to Mainwaring. He's given Pickering the slip, but the kick missed him. And the ball goes out of bounds after some solid body contact. And we'll have a throw in centre wing. A behind apiece. And just over 19 and a half minutes remaining in the first quarter. McKellar, back pocket play, going for the ruck. Comes Turner's way, but it's going to be McKellar's free kick. Now back to Michael Pickering. Pickering from centre wing, short of half forward. Honeybun is there, pulled off the mark. It slips aside. Weightman gets the hand pass to Thompson, but it goes behind him. Michael Thompson with a bit of time. Eagles need the pressure. Thompson's kick to half forward. Hogg trying to flip it out the back door. Worsfold.
Beautifully done by John Worsfold. Over to Guy McKenna. Lovely directed kick to Lewis. Lewis has brought the ground, still tapping it on. And good umpiring to let it go. And then eventually, the umpire set a trip. So it's a free kick going to Brendan Bauer. Chris Lewis, great to see him back in that Eagle side. He is a brilliant player. Lewis towards centre wing, punched away by Scott. Straight to Tony Free for Richmond. Free the short one to half forward. Good strong play by Brennan. Allows the ball to come wide towards half back and Murray Rance. And Rance cleverly heads for the boundary line and puts it over.
There's no other option there, Peter. Murray Rance, very experienced VFL player.
But great stuff from Hogg, the full forward, to put the pressure on and smother the hand pass out of bounds. Thompson in ruck. So the Tigers have used some unusual players for boundary throw-ins. Pike can't get boot to ball. The flip out comes to Lamb. His hand pass to Waters. He's kicked towards the centre of the ground. That was Waterman. Now a chance for the Tigers. This is Morris, who was named at half forward, started at half back. Goes to Peter Wilson. Goes for a bounce. Well, he kicked one from about 100 metres a couple of weeks ago. That's a beautiful kick to full forward. Just drops a bit short of Hogg. Actually, the mark should have been taken by Scott. Whipped out of defence by Miles, and the Eagles a chance to clear.
Miles, former Collingwood player, gets it to Mainwaring. He and Michael Pickering will have a terrific duel. Oh, Langdon, a pretty ordinary attempt to mark that one. What was going on there?
That shows a player out of confidence, I think, Karl Langdon. I just wasn't sure what was happening around him.
He's giving him the red rooster walk.
Well, here's Honeybun against O'Connell. Honeybun gets that one down in front. Shuffled out by Pickering to Free. Back it comes to Mainwaring, who is playing on Pickering. Well, there's Mainwaring on the left foot. Was an ordinary looking kick. It finds O'Connell. O'Connell almost smothered. In fact, it was. Oh, cleverly punched on towards half forward. It's shuffled away by Morris. Over to Lambert. Oh, he's going to be a great player, this youngster. He brings it to half forward. Oh, one-handed attempt up there was by Justin Pickering. Dwayne Lamb crashes his way through. Over to Mainwaring. Well done by the Eagles to Rance. Rance pretty slow to get rid of that kick, but he brings it to centre wing, looking down there for Turley. Or is it... Yes, it is Turley down there at centre wing, but it's taken away by Tony Free.
Kick by Free to half forward. Hogg from behind, Egan in front. But it's punched down by Brennan. Goes to Free again. Puts the kick wide with great vision. McKellar on the 50-metre line. Has time to steady and go for goal. And kicks a beauty.
And Richmond very good in that medium-sized batch of players that they have there. McKellar kicking that goal. And some very unusual shorts there. But McKellar finishing it off. Some good work by Richmond. Moved the ball well. Murray Rance did the wrong thing, bringing it out of the back line. Went for the short pass. It came unstuck and Richmond were able to run it up there into the forward line.
Six points the difference. The Tigers lead. Waterman tried to get it away and eventually it's Pike getting it down towards the half forward line. This is Waters, caught behind, almost gave away the free kick then. The umpire right under that one, and Allan McKellar will take it at half back. McKellar, who just kicked a lovely goal from the angle, brings
it in the back pocket, so he's kicked the goal from the back pocket.
Well, we often see that in modern day football. Here's Waters receiving from Lamb towards half forward. Should be a mark to Morrish, and in fact it is.
Morrish playing just his second game of VFL football. Changes direction to Michael Pickering. He's got support going past him, Wilson. And he tries to burn off the opposition. He's got Langdon in pursuit. Wilson's left footer is good to Egan. Couldn't quite handle. Worsfold gets the hand pass away. Turner to centre half forward. Free gets back there for the Tigers. O'Connell, number 21. Shuffles it out, goes to Lambert, who prefers to go with the hand pass, and he's great at that, to Free, who's been a star to date. But his kick not too good. Mainwaring drops. It comes back to McKenna, and Mainwaring will get a free kick against Dale Weightman.
Mainwaring getting plenty of possessions in this first quarter, and so is his opponent, as we see Mainwaring bring it down to centre wing. Scott was the fly, or copping it high was Lambert. And he comes up holding his head. I think he's had a bit of the old lemon rinse, Craig Lambert. As you see, very, very blonde in the hair as he brings it towards half forward. Manton was the flyer, couldn't take it. Egan crashes his way through. He's a very strong player, Egan. Brings it towards full forward. Hogg using the body against Brennan. Guy McKenna rowed beautifully. Well done by McKenna as he gets it to Brennan, and the Eagles get out of trouble as it comes out to Mainwaring again.
Tigers leading 7-1 at the moment. The kick to centre wing and the mark taken by Waters. It dashes away and drives it long to Jackson. Good lead. A great kick by Waters, but he couldn't take the mark. Honeybun on the boundary line. This is close to out of bounds. In fact, it floats over. And it'll be an Eagles free kick to be taken by Waters. Eagles still looking for their first goal. Centering kick. He's got to come across the mark. In fact, it's going up the ground to Langdon, 20 metres further afield.
Karl Langdon hasn't been in good form this year. Exciting player last year. Nice looking kick though, towards full forward. All the flyers are there. It's taken away by Honeybun. They got out of defence very easily, Richmond. Not enough pressure by the forwards as Free gets it out wide to Wilson. This is good football. Back to McKellar. McKellar on centre wing transfers the play to half forward, but beautiful judgment there by Guy McKenna.
McKenna at halfback. Across the halfback line to Rance, and he's got a runner inside in Pike. Rance goes for the long kick. To half forward, and a good running mark to Sumich. Too far out to score. Short pass to Lewis. If he can gather, it'll be a goal. Well, they put the pressure on him. Lewis fumbled. Still a chance. Lambert back there for the Tigers. Well played, son. Out to the halfback flank of Wilson, who's carving up Langdon at the moment.
There's Langdon now getting away. And a quick kick. Oh, he can't do anything right. Carl Langdon, he's put it out of bounds on the full, and John Todd not too happy with that piece of play. But Chris Lewis really messed it up a moment ago. He had a good chance to score a goal for the Eagles. Lambert towards halfback. There's Brian Lees taking the ball straight down the ground. Over the back is Worsfold. In fact, he chipped across in front and took a lovely mark. Good player, John Worsfold.
Long penetrating kick to half forward. The punch down comes to McKellar. He's kicked the only goal for the match. Up the centre wing. Weightman there with Lamb. Interference to Weightman. And the Richmond skipper gets the free kick. Takes it quickly. Centering to Egan, who marks in between centre and half forward.
Phil Egan, he's in everything at the moment. As I said him before, he's particularly strong and he's also quick. Oh, good lead by Hogg. Oh, come across it poorly and no worse foul. Caught. Justin Pickering's there. Umpire calling play on as Pickering brings in a short one. Mainwaring getting back defensively. He was good play, but he's lost it to Weightman. Weightman puts it to ground, trying to get the free kick. Now it's Egan having a pot shot, and he's missed it. And in fact, under pressure, has put it out of bounds on the full.
Well, I think, Peter, that he thought he was under a lot more pressure than he was, because there wasn't an Eagles player putting on a lot of pressure there, and he may have been able to steady and have a look and should have put that one through.
Geoff Miles to take the free kick for the Eagles. We have 11 and a half minutes to go to quarter time, and we've had just one goal in a very low scoring match. Free kick against Honeybun for his push out, and a free to Phil Scott. Up short of half forward, just kick and hope. That went nowhere near a teammate. The mark to Lees, who puts it wide to Michael Pickering. Tigers going forward again. Pickering straight up the centre corridor. No height there for Richmond. Over the top, an excellent mark taken by McKenna.
Well, he can really play, Guy McKenna. He's a particularly talented player and a great exponent of the handball. On this occasion, he's kicked it out wide. Dean Turner, Chris Lewis. Oh, good shepherding by Lewis. But oh, Pike took his eyes off the ball, and that allowed Bauer to take it away and bring it towards Manton. Rance is putting him under pressure. Manton still with the ball, loses it. Umpire calls play on. And a little clever little kick comes out to Waters over to Miles. Miles has gone wide and he's found Dean Turner.
Turner wide to the wing to Langdon. He's got a break on Wilson this time. But they're hugging the boundary line, the Eagles, to half forward flank. And a pretty simple measure there for Paul Morris to see the ball out of play.
Well, I don't know why Bernie went out that wide.
Well, they're obviously falling down on that half forward line and they haven't got a lot of confidence. And a lot of players there who can take the high mark.
They certainly haven't covered the loss of Ross Glendinning this year. There's Peters to McKellar to Free. Some of the youngsters combining there up towards Manton, who sets himself. Rance puts him under pressure. The ball fisted away. This is Worsfold. Over to Mainwaring. Oh, good, strong play by Chris Mainwaring. He's gone short to half forward and he found Connell to Pike. Pike's gone wide. This is better play. Now he should get this moving quickly, Sumich. Sumich 60 metres out from goal. He's taking too long to kick it. Now the lead is on, but he's gone to the pocket and he's going to ignore that Sumich. He's gone for the booming kick. It's a 60 metre one. Lewis sets himself in front. Over the back. I don't think that's a mark by Jackson. No, umpire didn't think so. Hand pass comes across to Lambert. Lambert wide to Brian Lees and Richmond get out of defence.
Lees wide to the wing. Michael Pickering interfered with and will take the free kick against Mainwaring. So I thought the conditions favoured high marking and brilliant attacking football today. Can't really say that with just one goal on the board. Under 10 minutes left to quarter time. The half forward and the ball out of play again.
Manton is playing at centre half forward for the Tigers and Murray Rance is playing at centre half back, so two players who were named at the opposite end of the ground fronting up on each other.
Scott hands to it, comes to McKellar, hooks it back towards full forward. Lounder with a lot of height there. Miles will need to jump all day to negate him. He does that. It comes to Worsfold up to centre wing. Wilson knocks away from Langdon. Wilson starting from behind, gets to the front. But the crumbs come out to Turley. Turley down the outer wing. Solid shepherd on Wilson behind play. Turley up towards centre wing. Now to half forward. Against Jackson for a push. Laffey the free kick.
Yes, Laffey playing in front. And those West Coast Eagles forwards will have to get in front. Oh, Honeybun's dropping a few easy marks today. That's not like him. Hand pass goes to Bauer. To Thompson. Oh, good play by Richmond. Wide to Michael Pickering. Now bounces with the left hand, has another one. Now he's going short towards half over. Gee, read that well, John Worsfold. That was just beautiful judgment.
Matter of fact, it's just as well Worsfold and McKenna have been on that half back line because they've held up a lot of attacks. Here's Waters, centre wing. He was playing on, bowled over in the tackle. Thompson bowled over as well. No whistle on that. Is there a whistle on that? No, play on, says the umpire again. Gee, it was tough in there. Comes to Knights. Centering kick, but straight to the advantage of Lewis.
Chris Lewis, oh, he took a punt there, and it might come off. Yes, it has to Dwayne Lamb in the centre of the ground. Lamb, the forwards fly over the back. Or actually, Sumich was over the back, but Lambert had it punched straight to him. He's gone to centre wing. Allan McKellar playing well. Michael Pickering on the left foot. The lead is on from Geoff Hogg. Out he comes. Sprints away from Brennan, hooks it back towards the goals, which way will it bounce? Back goes Miles, and saves the day and punches it through for a behind.
It's really a battle of the back lines at the moment. Another side with a forward who has been able to take possession of the ball. So I think that's what we'll see, because West Coast Eagles have not got many forwards here who are capable of kicking goals.
Pike was left a long way in the clear, but what a shocking kick. And the mark taken by Lambert, who bangs it back to the forward line. Hogg, good use of the body, but it comes again to Pike. Slips out the hand pass to Turley. One touch football. He needed it, didn't have it. Manton knocked off it. Lambert, another hand pass, a beauty to Egan. 60 metres out, up towards the forward pocket. That could be out on the full. The umpire saying it's to be a boundary throw-in. The boundary umpire ruled it came off his hand rather than shin or knee.
Yes, I think the boundary umpire was right too. It was pretty close. Lounder. Oh, well done by Scott to McKenna. McKenna, a 20-metre hand pass right across the face of goal to Miles. Beautiful play by the Eagles as we see Rance. Karl Langdon's in for a hard day against Wilson. Beautiful use of the body by Wilson. And he, oh, good skills too as he ducks away onto the left foot. A quick little kick is meant for Justin Pickering. Oh, cleverly done as he gets it across to Matthew Knights. Knights onto the left foot. Up they go. Lounder and Hogg. Hogg in front has taken a good strong mark.
Well, Miles there. Let's have a look at the replay. Good play by the Tigers, bringing it into the forward line. A long kick, and there's the two big Richmond players flying together. Hogg in front and Lounder behind, but he was able to keep the West Coast Eagles player out of the contest.
Geoff Hogg going for his first goal. A crowd of 11,000 here today at Waverley as Hogg kicks and has drifted it across the face. And a bad miss. Unlike him, he's normally a great kick. So Richmond wasting opportunities. They've moved on to 1-3 and the Eagles on one behind.
Miles, big task on the giant Richard Lounder today. Puts the kick wide to Lamb. Lamb's kick over half back to Turner. Manton spoils and sees the ball out of play. John Manton returning to the seniors for Richmond today. And Dean Turner, named as an interchange, but started in the 20. Scott, number 12, against Manton. Comes to Weightman. Now Knights, over the top to Lambert. Good football, nobody in front of him. His left footer is great to Hogg. Well, young Craig Lambert, what a player he is. We saw him play a couple of weeks ago with about 9 kicks and 22 handballs. But he's all right when he puts the boot onto the ball as well.
Yes, that was perfect delivery, Drew, from Lambert to a good lead from Geoff Hogg.
Lambert already 7 kicks, 4 hand passes and a mark. What an influence. Geoff Hogg from 50 metres. Kicks that one straight. And the Tigers have their second.
Much better kick there from Geoff Hogg. Looked very confident in going back. Kicked right through the ball. And that's his 99th goal in league football. So Geoff Hogg, I think, is the class forward on the field because the West Coast Eagles haven't got any strike power up there. And the Tigers also struggling a little bit at centre-half forward.
...14 points the difference, Richmond in front. The Eagles will have to get a move on because they are too high, the umpire said, on Dale Weightman. A little short one across to Michael Pickering, who's getting a lot of latitude. Back he comes to Matthew Knights again. Beautifully smothered by Lewis, who goes in to do the heavy work again. Mainwaring off the ground. Knights, cleverly done by the youngster. And he goes and gets it again. He's going to be a good player, Knights. To McKellar. McKellar, a short one to half forward. And it's Tony Free getting away from Guy McKenna. Now Free sprints away and brings it, centres it towards half forward. Up they go, Lounder at the back. Egan goes in after. The loose ball comes to Weightman. Well done by Dwayne Lamb, but the umpire said that he was pushed in the back. Well, I don't know about that one, but it was a bit ticky touch, but he's got the kick.
Let's have a look at that in replay. Weightman in for the ball first, and I think he may have received a push in the back.
Well, Dale's been tended to fall forward a few times during this first quarter playing for the free kick. He might have sucked the umpire in there, I think, Bernie. There's Dale Weightman. He's had 4 kicks and they've all been free kicks in this quarter. Well, there's the kick by Dale Weightman, and I might have sneaked this one in as he... Yes!
Well, there's no doubt he is a champion player, Dale Weightman. Been a great player for the Tigers over the years. Peter, I know you don't agree with that free kick, but Richmond at least are getting in and putting their body in the right position to receive the free kick. and that's where the West Coast Eagles are falling down. The Tigers are getting in first, getting the ball and doing the right thing, and the West Coast have to realise that they must get there first.
Just over 2 minutes left in the first quarter and the Eagles in a bit of bother already. Manton gets the hand pass to Michael Pickering. Off the ground by Lamb. Sprint on for the ball here. Oh, Lamb, a beautiful pickup. And a hand pass over the top to Free. Bumped off it, comes to Pike. He's kicked back to O'Connell, who marks outside of half forward. Short pass to Langdon. It looks as though, well, he left it behind him again. A chance for Wilson. Ball stays in. Might be a free kick to Lamb here, who's bowled over right on the boundary line. And Dwayne Lamb will take the free. Boy, do the Eagles need a goal before quarter time.
Well, Langdon won't be on the ground long if he keeps dropping marks like that. There's Lamb towards half foot. Again, those forwards playing from behind. And until they get in front and lead for the ball, they've got no hope. The ball comes to centre wing, that's Pickering, very strong overhead to Bauer, back to Pickering, back to Bauer, and Bauer from centre wing, oh, a bad head pass, but Pickering goes in and gets it again to Bauer. Bauer goes to ground, tapped cleverly back to Mainwaring, over to Lewis, let's see what they can do up forward now. Now that's a better piece of play as the lead was made by Sumich, and he has marked at the 50 metre line. Now he is a great kick of a football.
Yeah, there's a pass by Lewis, and that's about the first positive forward move that the Eagles have made.
Well, in the past they've been leading out to the pockets and out to the boundary line, and they won't score goals out here from there, but Sumich, this will be interesting because he's a very long kick of a football. Peter Sumich lays back and hooks that one across his body and puts it through for a, one behind. So the Eagles badly need goals. A great start by Richmond, and John Todd would not be happy at this stage. 3-3-21 Richmond, the West Coast Eagles, two behinds.
Kick to the outer side. Bauer in front, leaves it for Free. Back to Bauer. Bauer trying to centre the ball as much as he can. That's good play. McKellar, he goes out wide to Wilson. Siren sounds for quarter time. Bit of a disaster that for the Eagles. Richmond lead 3-3-21 to the Eagles, two behinds, 2 points. An ABC trained statistician, mate. It's on a card. David, the goal kickers for the Tigers, Weightman, McKellar and Hogg, one each, and of course the Eagles haven't managed a goal, and their forward setup, Bernie Quinlan, just looks non-existent.
Yes, well, they're getting to the ball second too, Drew. The Richmond, the young, enthusiastic Richmond side, they've been showing the Eagles the way to play the game. They have overused the handball on a couple of occasions, the Tigers, but they are very enthusiastic. They've got a full forward there, Geoff Hogg, in screen, who is a very good player, and some very good younger players who are running the ball out of the back line, down in their forward line. Very enthusiastic side, but as you said, the Eagles looking very ordinary on their forward line.
I see Drew, Karl Langdon is coming off, and no wonder, he had a disastrous first quarter.
Well, Peter Wilson just ran him around all over the place, and we thought that Langdon was going back to the WAFL this weekend, but was named, well, started in the 18 after being named an emergency, but now finds himself back on the bench.
Well, he seems to have lost all confidence. He dropped two easy marks. There's Guy McKenna. Well, he didn't let them down in that quarter. He was probably their best player. And worst fault, he also worked hard. Kevin Bartlett, there he is, the great Richmond champion, the record holder of over 400 league games, Kevin Bartlett. Brilliant player, kicked goals in finals, played well in nearly every final he played in, and he's doing a fine job with the young Richmond side.
Well, some of the statistics in the first quarter. for Richmond. Tony Free had 9 kicks in that first quarter, a total of 10 possessions with his one hand pass. McKellar outstanding with 7 handballs, 6 kicks, 13 possessions, and of course he kicked a goal. Pickering had 10 possessions, that's Michael Pickering. For the Eagles, their leaders were Lamb, McKenna and Mainwaring with 8 each, and Worsfold had 7 possessions. Free kicks were interesting. Tigers 13-5.
A big quarter this one, starting up for the West Coast Eagles. They really have to do something up forward and get themselves back into this game. At the moment they're not playing very well at all. Scott tries to get it down to Lewis. Now it's Mainwaring. Well, he's got it. Back it comes to Phil Scott. A quick kick to O'Connell and out in front. That's what they need. Their forwards playing in front. David O'Connell brings it to half forward. Fisted away back towards half back. Weightman cleverly. Over it went to Free, kicked off the ground, wide out wide. There's no one there for the Eagles though, as Matthew Knights takes the ball. Little chip pass across looking for Brian Lees, who was nearly crunched. He's taken the mark at half back for the Tigers.
Lees kick up towards half forward. Egan sets himself for a big climb, and can he leap? Not that time. Comes to Lamb, over the top to Lewis. Right down the centre, son. To centre half forward, kick too long for all the Eagles players, and Wilson dropped back to take the mark. Wilson goes out wide to Bauer. Bauer puts it out in front of Thompson. Scott comes across to chop him off and slip the hand pass to Turley. Craig Turley round the boundary line to Pike. Well, it's about 4 kicks to goal from there.
Yes, and they don't have confidence in their forwards either. Even then, Pike had to have a bounce. He's still looking for someone to kick it to. Now he has to kick it up high. Jackson pushes in the back. And the umpire had a beautiful view of that aside on. Again, Jackson playing from behind. And that's poor forward play. As we see, out wide is Lambert receiving from Pickering. Beautifully done. Crosser comes to Knights. He goes in after it as that hand pass was smothered to Pickering. And the umpire said, was that a throw, Bernie, was it?
Yes, he's called it a throw. And they're just getting themselves in trouble on occasions, Richmond, by just overuse of that handball.
Peter Sumich at half forward. Now,
it's to be Mainwaring's kick.
Mainwaring's kick will have to come back. And Mainwaring would be about 80 metres out from goal.
Sumich thought it was his. Now the Eagles still looking for their first goal. Chris Mainwaring from in between wing and half forward to drive it up to within goal scoring range. Very wide he goes with the kick and out of bounds before it could be touched by Hutton. And that was nowhere to kick from there.
That's bad forward work again. Hutton leading to the wrong position. He would have had a difficult shot for goal even if he had been able to mark that one.
Much better setting it up towards centre half forward. Well, you're in front of goal, but see if they can improve their forward play. There's Dwayne Lamb to Jackson, who has a quick kick at the goals. Stephen Jackson has put it out of bounds on the full, but I don't know what they can do, Bernie, with their setup. Maybe Rance down there at full forward even. He might be worth a try.
Yes, I think anything, because they just haven't got the goal-kicking power up there on the forward line.
Peter Wilson, hoist that one high. Honeybun. Almost outmarked by O'Connell. Free was after it. Lewis going backwards. Free kick against Lewis to McKellar. And Allan McKellar takes it at half-back flank. All of a sudden a different pattern emerges. Richmond in possession. Running to position towards the centre of the ground. McKellar's kick. Hoiked over the back is good play, but overrun by Michael Pickering. That could have been anything had he gathered that. Rance gets the hand pass back. Pickering's going to get a free kick. So Richmond really being favoured by the Freeze here.
Yeah, clever play there by Matten to hook that one back, give the Richmond player, the running players, a chance.
Well, as Drew said earlier, Richmond first for the ball. There's Egan playing for a free kick. Justin Pickering. McKenna's on top of him. And, well, another free kick. That's incredible. Well, they're getting in first. There's Egan, a poor kick. That could be a free kick to the Eagles this time. And it's Turner. And the umpire's going to bring it back. Dean Turner copped a heavy one as he attempted to take that mark. Now he's got Brennan out wide. Let's see what Michael Brennan can do. He's at half back. The short one is on the Pike. This might set up something. Now Pike was off. Yes, and the umpire thought so. He usually gets around Honeybun on Pike. A very highly skilled player as he brings it to half forward. I think Miles might have been moved to the forward line. The thrown off the ball was Jackson. Here's Weightman. Oh, brilliant handball to Knights. Knights is going inside to Bauer. Bauer wide to Lambert. Beautiful play by the Tigers as the ball is set up for Hogg. And that is a very, very good passage of play.
Brilliant football by the Tigers. Hogg from 55 metres to long kick. Lounder with the height. But he couldn't stop Lockyer getting a hand to it. And it goes through for a behind. So it's 3-4 to two behinds. 20-point lead to Richmond, whose rate of scoring has been way behind what we saw from them 2 weeks ago when they kicked 26 goals against North Melbourne. Oh, here's Weightman. Feeds out another great hand pass. Three runs onto it. Knocked off it. Weightman in there again for another one. And umpire Rowan Saw says, give it to me and I'll ball it up 40 metres from goal, right in front.
Well, actually, I don't think Kevin Bartlett would be all that happy either at the moment, because they should be further in front, the Tigers, on the play. There's Waters towards half-back. Now, no one there. Oh, there's one man there only in Don Pike for the Eagles. One on two and he gets it, hooks it back, but it was straight to McKellar. Now it's booted off the ground by O'Connell. But at half fourth, back for Richmond as Morris gets away easily. Long hand pass to Honeybun. Honeybun, oh, dangerous hand pass that one, because they've lost it to Sumich. It was a silly hand pass that one as it comes to centre wing McKellar. But still they're trying to create play. Bauer to Wilson. Wilson's got a loose man out wide and he's found Michael Thompson.
Well, the Richmond fans have started to cheer when somebody kicks the ball. Lots of hand passes from the Tigers. Here's a defensive mark to Brennan, who's had a hard time of it so far against Hogg, even though Hogg's only kicked one goal. Brennan out wide to Lewis. That half-back flank up to centre wing and a running mark to Miles. Well, that's kick and hope again, and Wilson takes the mark at half-back.
They're just not playing the ground very well, VFL Park, the West Coast Eagles. They're around the boundary and they're just playing the ground far too wide. They're not using the centre corridor, as David Parkin used to call it. And that's the shortest way home, and they need to do that.
Nine kicks for Peter Wilson, who's already had one opponent taken to the interchange bench in Langdon. Here's Lewis carving through a couple of opponents. His right foot at a full forward. Chance here for Jackson. He's got the mark. Jackson 25 to 30 metres out. And surely this will be the Eagles' first goal.
There's Lewis bringing the ball into the forward line. Still not a lot of movement on the forward line there from the West Coast Eagles. Jackson caught behind, not leading. And a little bit of a nudge out, but the umpire allowed the mark.
No breeze to speak of. No reason why he shouldn't kick this. And at last.
So Jackson kicks the Eagles' first goal. It's taken him a long time to get it on the board. 7.5 minutes into the second quarter. And really, looking at this side, the Eagles side, as compared to the one that played here against Melbourne in that elimination final last year, you just could not recognise this side as being the same sort of side. They've lost so many players, and they're just not the same side at all. Not playing with the same confidence.
Well, the Eagles are only 14 points down and they should be a lot further behind, and they're still in this game as we see Lewis getting it to half forward, taken away by Bauer. Towards half forward, Manton was grabbed by Mainwaring. It's shuffled over the top, out comes Justin Pickering. Quick kick to the pocket, it's fisted away from Geoff Hogg. Now it's Dwayne Lamb and Guy McKenna. He's got beautiful skills as he gets it across to Rance. Rance, now the Eagles look better. Don Pike, 55 metre kick up towards Hutton. Hutton, who fisted away back towards half forward. Allan McKellar waits for it. He does a little shuffle of the ball back. Out wide is Honeybun. Honeybun has time to steady and hook it back towards half forward. Rance is at the back, going for the fist, but what good mark by John Worsfold in front.
His kick almost underground to Turner. Centre of the ground, Waters stands his ground, takes a good mark. Richmond fans are not happy, but it was a mark. Waters kick out wide and a couple of Eagles have found themselves unattended. Hutton, not great distance, but it falls luckily for Jackson right in front, and Laffey left lamenting behind. And Stephen Jackson might get his second goal in 2 minutes here and put the Eagles right back into this. Straight kick will put them within 8 points. from just over 40 and squeezes it through.
So Jackson kicks his second, and the Eagles, unbelievable as it may seem, are right back in this match. They're not far behind because Richmond have had most of the play and just have not been able to convert their opportunities when they've had it on the forward line. And now Jackson's kicked two goals at the start of this second quarter, and the Eagles only 8 points behind. But that's their worry, Richmond. They have a few very ordinary players in the back line.
8 points the difference. And as Bernie Quinlan said, now Lewis playing well in this quarter, was the big fist away. There's Brian Lees, kick it out wide. McKellar and Waters, two youngsters against each other. Now that should be holding the ball. Oh, that is a very, very lucky decision. He had the ball and threw it away, Bernie.
Bad decision, Peter. He definitely had it, and when the tackle was applied, he just threw it away.
Well, very lucky to get that one. He's got some sort of a thigh support there, as you can see, a wetsuit type thing.
Like aerobic shorts.
The mark has been taken by Murray Rance, but the Eagles playing better football, and it looks good when Jackson's leading up the ground. The fist away, comes loose, kicked away by Miles towards half court, and the mark has been taken by Hutton. Now, the Richmond supporters didn't think it was a mark, but here's Hutton, the lead's on again. Now, Sumich and Jackson, but a good mark taken by Morris.
Well, Paul Morris playing just his second game of league football and first this season. Doing all right in defence. Turner, hand pass behind Mainwaring. Lewis, beaten to it by Free. Good contest there at ground level. Mainwaring comes out with it. The kick inside 50 now. Morris is back there. Good first time handling. Back to Wilson. This time hand passes to himself and keeps going, Peter Wilson. Well, the West Australian fans might like to see this stuff being displayed against the Eagles. It might have been an Eagles player, perhaps. Thompson goes backwards, on with the hand pass to Knights. His left footer, one out is Lounder. Well, good spoil by Lockyer. Egan in there to help Lounder. He paddles in. Turley back there for the Eagles.
Turley's gone wide to Guy McKenna. Let's see what he can do. He loves to handball McKenna, but this time he's going to kick it straight across the ground, and that's good play because he had an option of two men. One was Chris Lewis, who's playing a great quarter. Over goes to Brennan. Out wide is Pike. Don Pike, the leader's on. Jackson against Laffey. Good use of the body by Jackson. He couldn't quite take the mark, though, as Wilson crashes his way through. He's bumped off the ball. Jackson brought the ground. Now, he didn't have the ball that time. But maybe it was similar to the other one in a way, Bernie.
Well, he did take possession of it, and then when he saw the tackle to be about to be applied, let's have a look there. He took possession of it, and it may have been knocked out of his hands when the tackle was applied.
Stephen Jackson's kicked two goals in this quarter. Fourth kick as he brings it towards the goal square. Oh, what a, almost a mark to Pickering. Kicked off the ground by Pike, has hit the post. So the Eagles doing most of the attacking. They look a much better side in this quarter as they have moved on to 2-3. Richmond on 3-4, so 7 points the difference.
McKellar kicks in for the Tigers. And they've broken from that bunch at centre-half back and found players 20 metres in the clear. Free. Nobody to kick to on centre wing. Manton out number 2-1. Rance first there with help from Lewis. Chris Lewis from centre wing. Oh, Wilson dropping back into this one. Could have taken the mark. Tried to punch away. Hutton's his opponent this quarter. Oh, nice little hand pass comes out to Lamb. That was from O'Connell, but Lamb's kick astray. Lees, across the centre of the ground. McKenna's there, with help from Turley, who did a good bit of shepherding. McKellar's kicked to half forward, and the Eagles play, finding space. This is a bit more like Subiaco Oval and what they know. A solid shepherd behind play. A Tiger down, laid out, and the umpire coming in to speak to one of the West Coast Eagles players.
Geoff Miles.
And this is getting pretty heated now.
Looks like the Richmond player is out cold. Let's have a look at this. I was watching the play further upfield, but we'll see the...
It's hip and shoulder.
Well, it was hip and shoulder, Peter, but it was definitely more than 5 metres away from the play.
Michael Pickering.
Michael Pickering's a player. And He's definitely out cold, but it was a hip and shoulder by Miles, but it was unnecessary because Pickering wasn't a threat to the player that had the ball.
Wasn't in the play at all, I wouldn't have thought.
I think you'd call that modern day shepherding, Bernie. But at least the elbow didn't go up. It was hip and shoulder, which is not as bad, I suppose. But Michael Pickering doesn't look too good. I think just shows you the hip and shoulder hurts more than an elbow, I think.
And I think Pickering at the time was relaxed because he wasn't really putting in a hard chase. He knew the Eagles player was clear. And Miles just decided to put the hip and shoulder into Pickering. And probably the shoulder has made contact with Pickering's head. But he doesn't look very well. I don't think he'll take any further part in the match. He's definitely out cold. And really, it was an unnecessary bump.
So the stretcher comes out for Michael Pickering. Kevin Bartlett's going to have to reorganise the team a bit because Michael Pickering's one of those players who gives them such aerial strength. Richmond captain Dale Weightman showing concern.
There's something about Michael Pickering, Drew. He's got plenty of heart. He never takes his eyes off the ball.
Oh, well, that's disappointing to see. Any time a player has to be carried off in a stretcher, and Weightman, a tough little Tiger skipper, I'm sure won't be too happy about that one. Pickering has already had 8 kicks, 4 marks and 4 hand passes, so he's been in the play a lot, Michael Pickering. One of the classy Richmond players, and they'll miss him badly.
Well, that usually, when an incident like that happens, a player is hurt, often the side really lifts after that. It's enough to spur the team on, so that'll be interesting to see Richmond's reaction.
And Richmond making a double change because Justin Pickering's just left the field as well. And he has been replaced by Trevor Poole.
He's been well beaten by Guy McKenna, Bernie.
Yeah, well, that's true. Justin. McKenna has played a top game across the halfback line, but the two Pickering, the two brothers off the field, well, one won't be back on, I'm sure.
And Wayne Peters coming onto the ground for the Tigers as well. So both Pickerings off. Justin Pickering hardly been in the play, at least he walked off, but Michael Pickering, his older brother, is being carried off. So quite a long delay here at VFL Park, marking a pretty late finish to this game.
There's been 3 minutes time on added already. There's a player that put the hip and shoulder into Michael Pickering. It was Geoff Miles.
Well, a free kick was paid, but no notebook, so there was no report against Miles. Not that we could see, not from the field umpires anyway.
Now, Michael Pickering very relaxed when Miles ran through him, and I suppose it's a hip and shoulder, and hip and shoulders are fair in football, but it was an incident that was not necessary because he could have applied a shepherd without being as physical as that.
Dead right, Bernie. And he only had eyes for the ball, Pickering, Drew. There's a beautiful camera shot of that incident, but there's Dale Weightman. Let's see if it stirs the players into action. Manton drops that one, there's Lambert, he's caught. And a bit lucky to get away with that one as Honeybun. Quick kick up in the air. Oh, McKenna, oh gee, had to sit underneath that one. There's Hogg. Now he tries to get in the hand past Geoff Hogg. And players immediately tending to go in a lot harder. But gee, I felt for Guy McKenna then when he was running with the flight of the ball. He really could have been unloaded.
Big pack around this. Scott wins the tap. Can he find a teammate? Weightman gets the hand pass. It doesn't come clear. It comes to Rance. Now across to Mainwaring. Richmond 3-4, the Eagles 2-3. The Eagles have kicked the last two, but the kick goes out of bounds on the full, and we'll have a Richmond free kick just forward of centre wing, Lyndon Bauer.
Bauer towards half forward, Rance and Phil Scott try to punch it away. Worsfold's worked very, very hard as usual. Towards the halfback line he goes, and Mainwaring sees it over the line. But a very delicate situation, the game at the moment. 7 points the difference. Richmond much better first quarter than the Eagles, but the Eagles have been quite impressive in this quarter, particularly with Jackson taking a couple of marks and leading up the ground. Guy McKenna. Oh, that was magnificent skills by McKenna as he saw out of the corner of his eye Chris Lewis. Poor kick by Lewis, but it's found Sumich. Peter Sumich, that big wide arc. He swings onto the left foot and brings it to half forward, where Honeybunner's out marked. A good mark by Geoff Miles. He's getting the hoots with the Richmond supporters. Now let's see if Jackson can take another mark. No, Miles might have a shot. 45 metres out. Geoff Miles. Oh, top goal.
So Miles has been moved up on the forward line. Started the game in the back pocket playing on big Richard Lounder. Took a great mark there. And saw the opportunity. Honeybun on the mark. There he is running around Honeybun. Good play that, because Honeybun's not the most mobile player. And took the opportunity to run in and kick a very good goal, Geoff Miles.
So now the Eagles are within 1 point. They've kicked the last three goals. Just under 11 minutes to go to half-time. Well, they weren't in this game for a quarter and a half. But have they stormed back? Out of the centre again, but a mark to Lees of Richmond. He throws his arm back. This may be reversed. What's going to happen here? Umpire speaks to O'Connell. We've seen that reversed more often than once. He goes wide, Lees. And this is Peters, playing just his third senior game. Peters to half forward. Punch down comes from behind. McKenna gets the hand pass back to Worsfold. Across to Lewis, who's had a brilliant second quarter. Shows them the ball, takes it away from them. Puts the hand pass wide to Pike. To Turner. Out to Sumich, and the Eagles looking much better in the last 10 minutes. Sumich has kicked to Jackson in the forward pocket. Rovers wanted for the Eagles. Hutton to foot the ball. Knocked out of there by Morris for Richmond. Hutton over it again, and this will be a ball up.
Well, this is about 35 to 40 metres out from the Eagles' goal, but gee, I think John Todd's had a few stern words to them at quarter time, because they're working much harder now. Jackson, oh, cleverly. Turley receives from number 10 for the West Coast, Dean Turner, up towards Hutton. Hutton charging after, tries to tap it wide to Mainwaring. He's caught and hand passes it straight to the boundary line. The umpire said that was deliberate, unless he called it a throw, one of the two.
I don't see what other option he had there, Peter.
He was
completely surrounded.
He was gone for all money. As we see on screen, Wayne Peters bringing the ball out towards the half-back line.
Big climb by Scott, but he couldn't take the mark. At the back free. Taps for Weightman. Weightman's kick. New open spaces at half-forward. Nobody there. And the ball bounces out for a throw-in at half-forward for Richmond. They've come to a standstill. At one stage, they led 22-2. And now it's 22-21.
And there's the Richmond cheer squad, or a section of them, and well, they wouldn't be happy with what they're seeing at the moment. Eagles have got right back into this game. Oh, terrific skills there for the Tigers by Matthew Knights as he brings it to half forward. Geoff Hogg has got it, hooks it back towards the pocket. Is there someone there for Richmond? Yes, there is. Trevor Poole is on the ground, started on interchange, vice-captain of the club. And good play by Hogg.
Yes, good play and good courage there by Poole, running with the flight of the ball. We've seen him brought on a couple of occasions, Poole, after being on the bench, and he has lifted the Tigers' forward line.
Well, he is directly in front. He's playing on Guy McKenna now, replacing Justin Pickering. There's the kick by Poole. And Trevor Poole has missed. And that was a ugly-looking kick, that one, Bernie.
Yes, he can kick goals though, Peter, because he came on against North Melbourne a couple of weeks ago and kicked four in that second half.
Lockyer kicks in. Going 60 metres, marked by Scott. Flips away the hand pass to Turner. Over the top to centre wing. Good running by the Eagles now. Another goal will put them in front. Lamb to half forward. Sumich is there. Punches away from Wilson. Sumich follows up. Oh, but Lambert did well to get there, and a little toe poke across to Wilson. Loves to go for a run and a bounce. He's caught from behind. Great tackle by Pike, and the ball's out of bounds.
Chris Lewis not happy. He's having plenty to say. Chris Lewis on screen. I think he's saying it might have been holding the ball, because that was a good tackle, but I think he just got a quick hand pass in.
Good tackle. I think he may have spilled when he did apply the tackle.
Well, it's at half forward. O'Connell cleverly was looking for Turley. Shuffled out by Turner to Guy McKenna. McKenna is a beautiful handballer as he gets it to Lewis. Bit of skill between those two players. Up to full forward, and a very easy mark. Far too easy. Jackson took that mark, and I think Morris might have been moved to fullback.
It's far too easy. The Tigers falling down now. Their back line is a little bit weak. They haven't got very good key position players in the two key posts, but Jackson there, far too easy taking that mark.
Well, he's kicked two, Stephen Jackson, and he has played a good quarter of football. He's deliberating over this one, winding it up, going for his third from directly in front, 15 metres out. And that could be a 50-metre penalty against Brian Lees. And now it'll be a certain goal.
Well, the player just far too close to the mark and they've paid the penalty. This is a certain goal now.
Lewis, who passed that for this quarter, has had 9 kicks, 3 marks and 2 hand passes in the centre of the ground. There's the kick by Jackson, and that's his third.
And all in this quarter too, Peter. So the Eagles looking far better. They've hit the front. And Richmond have come to a standstill. They've made a couple of changes at quarter time. With Langdon off the ground, their forward line is looking a bit better. Sumich is moving around well. Miles has given them a lift. And of course Jackson there on the forward line with those 3 goals. But the Tigers, I think, have got a few worries with their key position defenders.
So Jackson with a new opponent, Morrish. Laffey has gone out and was on Hutton. And Sumich has Peter Wilson. So Wilson's got about his third opponent. And now O'Connell from the centre of the ground. High to half forward. Big pack. Sumich. Eagles in front by 4 points. We've got just over 6 minutes remaining to half time. And all of a sudden the forward line, which we're pretty critical of in the first quarter, has produced Jackson with 3 goals and Sumich lining up for one from about 52 metres. Very slight breeze into him, that's all. Raking kick. Oh, beautiful kick for a goal.
That was a magnificent kick there by Sumich. Kicked it from just on or just outside the 50-metre line, but he is looking a good player, Peter Sumich. Missed a couple of weeks with a leg injury or a hamstring injury, but back in this side, can take a strong mark. Kicks the ball long distances and accurately, but the forward line looking a lot better now with Miles, Sumich and Jackson all combining very well.
The Eagles lead by 10 points. Let's see if the Tigers can come back. That's McKellar, a hand pass across to Michael Thompson, the long kick. Geoff Hogg up in front. Take it away from him by Dale Weightman. He punches the ball away. He's playing for too many free kicks, Dale, today, as we see Guy McKenna tapping it back to Worsfold. Those two players have been excellent. Brennan been putting Hogg under a lot of pressure too, with Brennan beautifully across to Lamb, and the Eagles really playing good football now. O'Connell, oh, free kick to O'Connell for in the back. That'll have to come back. He was nudged out as he went for that mark. David O'Connell, and you better hand it back quickly, Peter Wilson. David O'Connell, umpire right onto that. Now he's gone out to the pocket. Sumich against Lamb, but he should mark Sumich. That's an unfair contest. And Sumich has really livened up that forward line.
He's far too tall there for Lambert. He looks quite a good player, Peter Sumich. Haven't seen a lot of him, but moves around well, can take a grab, and he does kick very well.
Well, he kicked a raking goal a moment ago outside the 50-metre line. And he's got a lovely kicking style. He runs out to the left a bit and drives the ball hard. There it is again. It's coming back. Yes, it's another one.
So the West Coast Eagles looking a lot better now. Sumich kicking his second goal for the quarter. And Stephen Jackson has kicked 3 for the quarter. So their forward line that we criticised a lot in that first quarter has come to life. And as I said, the Richmond defenders, a couple of those players looking a little bit ordinary. They haven't been playing closely enough to their opponents.
Well, the Eagles have slammed on 6 goals, 1-1 behind, and all of a sudden lead by 16 points. Bounce back in the centre. Scott hands to it. Here goes Peters. Scott, little toe poke out of the middle. Wilson charges at it, went behind. Comes to Knights. Hand pass up in the air. Still in that congested pack. Sumich gets a kick out of there. Miles, an awkward one. Comes to Bauer. Kicks across the half-back line. Michael Thompson leads the race. He's about 20 metres in the clear, but the ball might win anyway. was pretty happy that it did. And we'll have a boundary throw in. So actually it's 6-1 to 2 behinds. And the Eagles have just turned the complexion of this game. So if you're watching in WA and friends or relatives have given this away at quarter time, you'd better get them back to the TV set.
Well, here's Don Pike. It's an amazing recovery. And I think Chris Lewis has made all the difference in the centre of the ground. There's another mark. Now, that could be 50. No. And that's is that Jackson again. Let's see. Yes, it's Jackson, Stephen Jackson. He's already kicked three.
And the Eagles bringing the ball more direct this quarter. Down the centre of the ground, Jackson taking that mark from behind. Looks very impressive. Coming up for his seventh kick. And going for the fourth, his fourth goal of the quarter.
Well, very impressive display this by the Eagles in this quarter. Amazing turnaround and good to see them playing the sort of football we know they can. This man will make a big difference if he can create a, be a focal point for them. There's a floater. And I think it sneaked in. It did.
So Jackson kicks his fourth for the quarter, fourth for the match. And with Sumich and Miles playing also well in this quarter, they suddenly have got a forward line that is functioning. And the Tigers really have come to a standstill, playing very poor football, not getting the ball out of the centre. The Eagles winning most of the centre bounces, winning at a ground level and giving the forwards the opportunities to kick the goals.
So that's now the Eagles. They've kicked seven goals while Richmond haven't advanced. Honeybun wins out of the middle. Mainwaring first back there. His left footer through the centre circle it goes. Wilson charges onto it. He's on Sumich now. He's kicked two this quarter. The hand pass is straight at Turley. Wide for Hutton. Who beats Laffey to it. And Richmond's defence is proving a problem to Kevin Bartlett at the moment. Hutton goes long to the edge of the square. Pike is there but no height. Is that a mark at the back? Pike snaps for goal but misses.
You know, Connell nearly grabbed that mark over the back of the pack. He had his hands on and just didn't quite hold it long enough. There's David O'Connell sharing the ruck work with Phil Scott. Paul Morris has been moved to full back. Laffey's been moved away from Jackson. The kick out wide to Honeybun. Foster Lambert, who's been a lot quieter in this quarter as he brings it to half foot on Manton. Lance has thrashed John Manton. He ducked the hit on that occasion, and that's a sign of a man who is under a lot of pressure there. Doing well, Manton. Rance. Rance to half forward. Bauer. Oh, Richmond look terrible at the moment. Turley beautifully to O'Connell. O'Connell on open goal. He should chip it across. No, he won't. He's going in close and he might have missed. He's hit the post. Had two men to give it to. He wasn't sure whether the handball or not.
Well, he was in a bit of a dilemma there because the Richmond player was closing in very quickly. And the Richmond player really didn't go hard. He decided to hang back and put a bit of doubt in his mind.
Wilson continuing to get a lot of touches up towards the centre of the ground. Honeybun just paddled it on. Is that a high tackle? Yes. Free kick to McKellar. Well, Richmond need to find a spark. Egan breaks the tackle. His left footer high to the 50 metre line. Ball's hooked infield. Worsfold's good enough. His hand pass partly blocked. Goes to Egan. Chance for the Tigers here. His left footer up towards the goal square. Good mark, Peters, right on the edge of the square.
There's Egan bringing the ball. Good centering kick there from Egan on the left foot. And Peters chipping in. A couple of players stationary there. Gave him the opportunity to float across the front of the pack and take a good mark.
Well, just 20 seconds left for the quarter. This will be their first goal for the turf.
So Peters, who came on halfway through the quarter when Justin Pickering was replaced, has kicked Richmond's first goal for the quarter. It's been a very bad quarter of football for Richmond. West Coast Eagles have taken it right up to them and have completely dominated the quarter. Richmond just have not been in the game.
So hardly any time to get a score out of the centre bounce. 7 seconds remain to half time. And while the Tigers went to sleep, the Eagles added 7 goals. Honeybun wins in the middle. Charging through is Turner. The siren will beat them all. Turley away to Scott. Before Sumich could get the ball. It's half-time here at VFL Park. The Eagles 7-5, leading the Tigers 4-5. Usually they've been doing it from match to match, but today they've done it from quarter to quarter. We just wonder what they're capable of. By Rowan Soares, getting the second half underway. 7-goal second quarter to the Eagles. Ball comes underfoot from the ruckman. They can't get it out of there, and they'll ball it up again. Well, would you like to have a stab, boys? Who do you think will win?
Well, I'm going for the Eagles. I think Richmond looked hopeless in that second quarter.
I agree.
Well, the defence had plenty of holes in it. Wilson gets it out of the centre, up towards Manton. Knocked away from him. Comes to Lamb. Weightman shepherded off him. Good kick by Lamb to Turley.
Blake Turley from half-back has gone short to the centre of the ground. The mark has been taken by Scott. And the Eagles looking good already in this quarter as they bring it down towards half-forward. Oh, tall man at the back. Couldn't take the mark though as it's Honeybun. To Thompson was a wild hand pass. Back it comes to Bauer. Now Turley goes in and grabs the ball. Cops one high. It's in a quick hand pass. Lambert in after it. And he almost loses it. Now he's got a Craig Lambert. And he's gone with a wild, another wild hand pass out towards Egan. McKenna's got him. Back it comes to McKenna's opponent. Justin Pickering is back on the ground. He finds McKellar. McKellar from centre wing to Peter Wilson. Wilson sprints away. Has a bounce. Let's see what he can do with it. He swings onto the left foot and a beautiful pass. Good play by Wilson. It's found Geoff Hogg.
Now, Hogg needs to be accurate here. And Wilson with a couple of bounces. And what a pass it was. Man on the mark, 40 metres from goal. This to narrow the gap to 2 goals. Great kick. Just offline though. Hogg 1-2 for the afternoon.
Geoff Hogg has a lot of ability and could develop into a top full forward. He's keeping Michael Roach out of the side at the moment. Andrew Lockyer, or a short one, dangerous to Brennan. This could be very costly because Dale Weightman picks it up, kicks straight into Guy McKenna coming towards him, and Weightman appealing for the free kick, but he's done far too much of that today, Bernie.
Yes, I agree. There was no free kick there, Peter. Just playing for it. Good play there by McKenna. Here we see it again, and Weightman just threw himself back. Hardly touched by McKenna.
Well, it's in that forward pocket. That was Dwayne Lamb trying to get his kick to it. Now it's Lewis after that sensational second quarter. It's tapped away to Justin Pickering. Here's a chance. Lambert from 30 metres straightens up and hooks it slightly and has put it through for a behind.
Brennan kicks in. Lockyer. Wide to the wing to O'Connell. Couldn't take the mark. It's all Richmond at ground level. Egan first back there. Philip Egan, short of half forward. Manton, who was limping a moment ago, in the hands of the trainers. Peters, high to centre half forward. No height there for Richmond. Good contest for the ball here. Wilson, done some spectacular things, Peter Wilson, to Thompson. Poole had to get rid of it in a hurry. Does so to Knights. Good looking kick. Hogg. One touch. Couldn't come down with it. Off to Brennan.
Brennan to the centre of the ground looking for Turley. Oh, it's cleverly tapped away by Norwich to Honeybun. Now it's on to Egan. The long kick. Hogg at the back. Lockyer at the front. Oh, Hogg cleverly got in front, but Lockyer comes back and brings it towards the pocket. Or centre wing, I should say. It's taken by Peters. Peters, a long booming kick. Geoff Hogg against Lockyer. Back it comes to Knights. And eventually it's forced over the line and through for a behind to Richmond. But they're doing most of the attacking early in this third quarter here at VFL Park. The scoreboard shows the Eagles leading 7-5-47 to Richmond 4-8-32.
The Tigers have managed 3 behinds in this quarter. Lewis to half-back flank. Good mark taken out there by McKenna. Short passes. to Pike. Zigzag play by the Eagles, setting it up. Oh, excellent mark by Miles, who's the villain of the piece after the clash with Michael Pickering in the second quarter. To half forward, almost a one-hander. Was he held? Bauer picks up the crumbs, feeds it out wide to Peters. He's been in a lot of play since he came off the bench, halfway through the second quarter. Punched down by Rance, goes to Turley. Turley threads out a good hand pass to Scott, and away they go further. It was Waterman up towards forward pocket. Jackson, who kicked four goals in the second quarter. Back he goes. Hoisted high, up towards the goal square. No mark, is it? Yes, the mark is paid to Waters. I'd like to see that again.
I think Laffey felt he had that one, Drew.
I think that may have been stolen. There's Sumich with the kick. Good high centering kick. And Laffey, I think, had first hands on it, but Waters came down with it.
Scott Waters going for his first score for the match. Gets the goal.
So a very handy goal there to the West Coast Eagles. Richmond doing all the attacking at the start of the quarter, not able to convert, and the Eagles get it up there on the one occasion. Waters takes well. I think it may have been a little bit of a controversial mark, and only had the shot from about 10 metres out.
Eagles lead by 21 points after that mark to Scott Waters. Honeybun gets that one down to the ground. That was Wilson at the base of the pack. The umpire said he made no attempt to get rid of it. That's holding the ball. Worsfold has worked particularly hard. He put a big heart, John Worsfold, as he brings it wide. Waters in after it. That was good play by the youngster over the pike. Pike with a long hand pass towards half forward. Tapped away by Jackson. Cross to Mainwaring. A quick kick in front of goal. Let's see what Hutton can do. It's shuffled back towards Miles. Miles shuffles it out. Mainwaring, an open goal, slams it through.
So the West Coast Eagles, two quick goals at the start of the third quarter. Good play by Miles there in the forward line. Been changed from the back line after spending the first quarter on Lounder, who is now off the ground. Geoff Miles setting up quite a few chances for the forwards there, and the Eagles also getting the ball out of the middle, which is making a big difference to their side, getting plenty of run into their side, and Lewis is playing a brilliant game in the middle.
Biggest lead of the game, a 27 point advantage to the West Coast Eagles. Phil Scott in against David Honeybun. Honeybun wins that to Weightman. He's kicked to half forward. Rance gets back there. Doesn't come out with a ball though. Gee, Worsfold just escaped the tackle there. Bad bounce for Egan. Put him under the hammer. He'll have to go back with a hand pass. It's blocked by Lewis. Egan again. Oh, great play by Philip Egan. Wins the free kick. Not sure that I saw a push in the back, but he pretty well earned it. That goes across the ground and maybe backwards to Honeybun, who pops it over the top to Lambert. Now Richmond going around in circles, wide to Hogg. Just inside 50, the umpire will ball it up.
Well, Geoff Hogg's trying hard and he's leading all the time, doing all the right things, but he's finding it hard to find the spaces, and Richmond players not being able to give it to him at the moment. Also, he's got Lockyer wearing him very, very closely. That's a hit out coming out to Lewis. And he's a very exciting player, Chris Lewis. There he is. Missed a couple of games, or a few of the early games when he went missing. But great to have him back in that West Coast Eagles side because he's a great crowd pleaser. There's Scott over the back. That's Waters, a quick kick to Miles. And the Richmond supporters don't like him after a hip and shoulder bump put Michael Pickering off the ground. Mark has been taken by O'Connell on centre wing. David O'Connell brings it towards half forward. Honeybun should mark this. He's very strong overhead as he takes it at half back flank.
Honeybun across the half back line to Lees. Sweeps a 20 metre hand pass up the ground. Trevor Poole. Good run by Poole. Hogg's there. Punched down by Lockyer, doing well. Comes to Knight. Ducks a high tackle. Play on, says the umpire. Lockyer. Lewis, a great pickup, but not a great kick. Fortunately, it's picked up by Mainwaring. Straight up the centre, Mainwaring. Bit of a box on behind play. Lees. Egan. Goes back to Honeybun, who puts it out wide again.
Yes, but this might favour the Eagles. I know the Eagles player Brennan overran it. It's Lambert. Oh, top one across the head, but he's pretty tough, Lambert. He just struck that and went straight on with the kick. There's Worsfold. And Dean Turner. Turner carries it towards the boundary line. Good play, Dean Turner. Then tries to get in the hand pass. Good umpiring to call play on. And now he comes in to bounce it. But there was no free kick in that. That was Richmond supporters thought so, Bernie.
No, good play. Good umpiring and good courageous play by Dean Turner. Kept his head down, kept his eyes on the ball. Tenacious play.
Eagles leading by 27 points with 16 minutes remaining to three-quarter time. McKenna, clever kick, Miles. Geoff Miles on the run. Kick to centre half forward. Well done by Hutton, but he infringed. Pushed Laffey in the back and gave away the free kick. He was charging off to an open goal square. So pretty important free kick, that one. Laffey to centre half forward. Manton up before acceptors. McKenna, Turley. Eagles back into attack. Morris. First back there, one way, then the other. Puts it wide to Free.
Tony Free from half back, hooks it back. Now Turley went back, couldn't take the mark. Guy McKenna went in against Egan. Egan tried to boot it off the ground, but it came off the hands of Justin Pickering and over the line. The scoreboard shows the Eagles with a good lead. 9-5-59 to Richmond, 4-8-32. And we're on centre wing. Honeybun against Phil Scott, pretty evenly matched in height and weight. There's Wilson going in hard. He's lost it though to McKenna. Clever little hand pass finds Waters. Back it went to Rance. Rance a hurry kick out. Well, fire. Here's a loose man coming up. Turley smothered as he went to kick it. No, it wasn't. It was in fact out of bounds on the full. So it'll be a Richmond free kick. And the recipient is David Honeybun.
And Free takes the kick. So he earned it in the first place. Putting the pressure on to force that ball out on the full. Here's Poole. Kicked by Poole in the direction of Mantons. Hardly had his hands on it all day. Oh, Lewis gets it back to Mainwaring. Off to Scott. Scott's kick covers 50 metres to half forward. Big climb by Hutton, but no mark. Laffey. Untidy looking defender. Goes across the ground, slightly backwards in fact, to Lees. Steers the pass for Wilson. He's got it again. Quickly off with a hand pass to Free. Free up towards half forward. Weightman pushed the ground and gets another free kick.
Yes, no doubt about that one. And that ball will have to be relayed back. That was an obvious one right in the middle of the back. West Coast Eagles man now. That looks like Sumich. Could be hurt down behind the play. And we'll try and pick that up in a moment. But the lead is on by Hogg. Oh, punch from everywhere, Geoff Hogg. And I did think he copped it in the head from the front. The umpire saying it was over the shoulder, but he had three Eagles men come at him.
Yes, it wasn't a very good pass because Hogg was well covered. There's a replay, a kick from Weightman. And I thought it was just good, tough tackling by the West Coast Eagles. And well, they had a go for it, Peter, and they did everything they could to spoil.
Andrew Locke is having plenty to say there as Geoff Hogg goes for his second goal from 40 metres. No doubt about it. Straight through.
So that goal gives Geoff Hogg 100 goals in VFL football after playing 61 VFL games. He joined Richmond from Mount Waverley High in 1968 and he's taken over from Michael Roach. He's been a good player at full forward. He's keeping Michael Roach out of the side. And has done a good job, although his kicking hasn't been all that accurate today.
Vital goal that for the Tigers, reducing the margin to 21 points. Richmond out of the middle through Manton. Wide to half forward. Nobody there for Richmond. Rance 25 metres in the clear. Poor kick by Rance. He had a lot more time than that. And Peters took the mark on centre wing. Wayne Peters, the youngster, 19 years of age, playing his third VFL game. Climbed by Hogg up the ground. Looks as though Egan's gone to full forward for Richmond, and it's a free kick to Hogg.
Yes, and that's exactly right. The lead's on by Egan. Hogg, oh, beautiful play by Hogg. And what a good lead, and it might be a good coaching move, that one, Bernie.
Yeah, that is a good move. A very good move by Kevin Bartlett. There's Hogg playing at centre-half forward. They've had nothing at centre-half forward. Matton has been well beaten. And Egan has gone to full forward on numerous occasions and kicked plenty of goals. So very good move by Kevin.
Well, actually, Manton should have been left, should have been shifted much earlier. I thought Rance was killing him in the first half. And this is Philip Egan. Oh, boy, if he can kick this one, the Eagles will be under a bit of pressure. There's the kick. It's through.
So that move just made a minute or so ago has already paid dividends. Philip Egan, not tall to be playing at full forward, only 180 centimetres, and he's kicked 103 goals in his league career, that one being his 104th. So Richmond still not out of this game, coming back, only 15 points down now,
and they've just moved Guy McKenna on to Philip Egan, a good move. Points of difference. Guy McKenna's now moved on to Philip Egan. A quick move that by John Todd, and a smart move because Guy McKenna can match him for skill and for pace. So good thinking by John Todd. There's the Richmond supporters of, and there's Guy McKenna. A big job because Egan can kick goals at full forward. Only 15 points now the difference. There's John Worsfold. A quick one down towards Lewis and O'Connell. Miles is there also. Kicked off the ground by O'Connell. Right down towards the pocket. Hutton against Laffey. Hutton a touch of the fumbles. Cleverly taps it back. There's only one man there. And it's Wayne Peters for Richmond. What's happened in the meantime?
It's a free kick against Laffey for being in the back of Hutton.
Well, this is Hutton. It was costly because Richmond were up and away. There's Kevin Bartlett. Now Hutton centres the ball. Can someone take a big mark? Lees, quick hand pass. Very good defensive play by Richmond, and they take it over the line. But I think we've got a real ball game on our hands now. Richmond coming back.
So Lockyer's gone out with Hogg to half forward. Hogg at half forward, Lockyer at half back. Chance for the Eagles here. Lambert's there, number four for the Tigers, and the umpire will ball it up. So Richmond got away, they kicked the first three goals for the match. The Eagles kicked the next seven. And now 15 points the difference. Free kicks are 30 to 11 in favour of Richmond. Free can't get a handle on the ball. Waters have taken it out, so we'll have a boundary throw in.
It's amazing when you look at free kicks. It's amazing how often the home side gets more free kicks than the visitors. It happens in nearly every ground. As we see the ball at half back. Cleverly tapped away by Wilson. It's gone straight to Turley. Turley a quick one to Mainwaring. And Richmond wouldn't want the Eagles now to retaliate with a quick goal. That leads on to Lewis. All unmarked. And that's loose checking because Lewis, well, he'll still have to kick from about 47 metres. Lewis has had 13 kicks.
And a very good player, Chris Lewis, since quarter time. I think he's a player that, who has been responsible for putting the Eagles in front.
Well, he's directly in front. He kicks right on the 50-metre line. He lays back, and as he laid back, he had to push it wide. And he does so and puts it through for a point. But still not out of the woods yet. 44 to 60, 16 points the difference. Eagles in front.
McKellar back towards the back pocket. Up for Bauer. Oh, played that well against Lewis. Hauled it in with one hand. Brendan Bauer to half forward, a kick very wide, too wide for Hogg. It was poor disposal and out of play.
Yes, they've let themselves down on numerous occasions, Richmond. They've had possession of the ball, and with sloppy hand passing and foot disposal, they've given the ball away.
Rance and Manton to do the ruck work. Oh, Rance, clean possession. Manton nowhere near it. To half forward for the Eagles. Honeybun, a big mark. Gee, he's been in great form in the last month.
Yes, he's taken numerous marks and tremendous overhead mark, David Honeybun. On the left foot, he's gone wide. Oh, this could be costly because Trevor Poole's lost it. Morris is in there. Turley. And the umpire's found the free kick Richmond's way. They're pushing the back. And it will go to Paul Morris. No, it's not. Is it Honeybun who's got it? Let's have a look. In fact, it was Honeybun towards centre wing. Oh, Hogg moving well at half forward. Good move by Kevin Bartlett. He brings it out wide. Chance for Lees, pressing his way through. Now it's Matthew Knights. Egan's on the lead. McKenna at the back. He's slipped McKenna. Good lead. Beautiful disposal left by Matthew Knights.
And McKenna paying the price there for watching the flight of the ball and not watching where his opponent was leading. And Philip Egan is a very good leader. So McKenna better be very careful.
Philip Egan has already kicked one. And he can make the margin 10 points if he puts this one through. He's only 20 metres out, 45 degree angle. Plenty of concentration by Philip Egan. Normally a good kick for goal. A vital kick this one for the Tigers. Oh, it's a shocker. I think it went the wrong side, did it? Yes, wrong side of the post. You couldn't see a worse kick than that anywhere.
Well, I think he took a bigger divot than you would, Peter, playing golf.
A wedge shot, Drew.
A rotten kick. So a reprieve there for McKenna, who looked like having a goal against him quickly there. To Rance, kick short of the wing. Lewis climbs at the back, can't mark, but quick to recover. He's legged. Free kick was going to be paid and will be paid. It's got to come back to Chris Lewis. Lewis coming up for his 14th kick.
Remind me not to say a guy's a good kick again, yeah. Please, Drew. They let you down every time you say that.
Well, I'm sure there'll be a few viewers in Western Australia going crook about the free kick tally here today. In front, Honeybun. The Eagles have got nobody to match him really in the air. He goes across the ground, dangerous here. More Mainwaring, just beaten to it by Bauer, who tapped out to Lambert, and that was just as well for the Tigers. Now it's open. Good shepherding behind play. Lambert, time to fumble. Puts the hand pass away to Michael Thompson. Up the ground to Manton, but very wide. That is shocking play by Richmond. They've gone handball crazy.
Richmond crowd didn't think that was out of bounds. They're going berserk down there, Drew, but Johnny Manton's had a bad day today. It was a bad hand pass. That wasn't his fault on that occasion. Manton shuffles it out to Lambert. Oh, they've got a loose man wide. In fact, they've got two. Oh, good play by Mainwaring to come across. A quick kick comes down towards the forward line. McKenna in front. Lockyer at the back. Andrew Lockyer, a shocking hand pass. Caught. Now he gets in the hand pass to Turner. Turner to the boundary line and puts it over, and the umpire said it was holding the man. And it is Dean Turner's free kick in the hands of the trainers, Wayne Peters.
He was slung very heavily by the Eagles player when he kicked the ball and hit the ground very hard.
Geez, played well since he came on though. Free kick in across the goal mouth to Lamb. Oh, 20 metres in the clear. Is Jackson. Steers the ball to half forward. Good pass. That comes off here to Waters from 50 metres. Nobody back there. Great goal for the Eagles.
Very good goal to Scott Waters. His second, and the Eagles going much more direct since quarter time. When they didn't kick a goal in that first quarter. They've kicked 10 goals since the break, but they're been bringing the ball much more directly into the forward line, and it has paid dividends because in that first quarter they were very wide going around the flanks. They were leading wide and weren't getting any results.
To 6-9, 66-45, so that's 21 points again the lead. And Honeybun tries to tap it out. This is Jackson. Oh, clever little hand pass to Worsfold. Up in the air to Turley. Turley. Mainwaring. Good hand pass to Lamb. Here's danger for Richmond as Lamb comes to half forward, but ducking back. Good strong mark by Brendan Bauer.
Good treatment there from Sumich.
Yeah, there was a bit of treatment too. Sumich not really looking where the ball was and just threw a bit of a wild one.
Well, bad old kick off the side of the boot. Good mark to Honeybun, who was out number 2-1. Thompson runs off him. To half forward, and Hogg sets himself. Lockyer up high. Comes to Knights. The hand pass to Poole. Puts it wide to McKellar. Close to the boundary line. Goes for the goal. Just misses.
Points the difference as Lewis marks at half back, and they're trying hard, Richmond, but the Eagles are a very skillful side, use the ball well, and Lewis giving the directions out there like a major general. He's gone wide to O'Connell, never seems to just quite hold his marks long enough. O'Connell, that's Turley towards half forward. Hutton working hard, ducks back after it. Hutton, good play out to Mainwaring. Good play by Hutton. Real good team players. We see coming down the ground, Chris Mainwaring. He's got a goal, an open goal from the boundary line, and he has missed. So the idea there, Bernie, obviously would have been if there was a man there to chip it across, but I don't think anyone thought of that.
There wasn't much pressure being applied by Richmond. Mainwaring able to run a long way into an open goal.
Lees kicks in. Just over 3 minutes left to three-quarter time. And the Eagles leading by 21 points. Hoisted back towards the goal square here. Chance for Sumich. It's going to be a free kick right in front of goal to the... Oh, Richmond. Oh. Well, I was waiting for the decision. It looked for a moment like the umpire was going to pay the Eagles.
I thought if he had paid the Eagles, they would have torn the rafters down, Drew.
So it's Brian Lees with the free kick over half-back. McKellar in front. A mark. Two and a half minutes to go to three-quarter time. McKellar to the centre wing. Lantern, again no mark on Rance. And now a ball up.
Well, it's on centre wing. Umpire Rowan Saws is John Worsfold. Rance. McKellar. Started off well early, Allan McKellar. This is Lambert. Over the top to Peters. Peters to half forward. Oh, good strong mark by Matthew Knights, and he wants to play on. This guy's going to be an excellent player, Matthew Knights. He hooks it back. This might bounce over and through. Was that touched? I don't think that was touched. I think this will be a goal. Yes.
It's going to be a free kick anyway. The umpire ran in signalling there had been a push out. The Richmond player in the forward line, I think it was Geoff Hogg, would have received the free kick anyway. But it didn't matter because Hogg's kick was not touched. I mean, Knight's kick was not touched and dribbled through for a good goal to Richmond. A handy goal coming up to the three-quarter time break.
Now just 15 points the difference. Honeybun wins the tap. It comes to Poole. He gets the hand pass away to Weightman. And it's socket away from him. Honeybun trying to paddle the ball out. Loses it to Turley. Turley gets help from Lamb. His left footer up inside half forward. Chance for the Eagles here. A mark to Scott.
Yeah, Scott playing on the forward line now. Resting up there. The kick travelling a little bit further than Lee's expected. Now a big chance for the Eagles.
Just 25 metres out, and Scott steers it through.
So a quick reply there by the Eagles. Phil Scott resting on the forward line. Has kicked goals on a number of occasions for the Eagles. Can play up on the forward line. Kicked 7 goals in the opening match of the season. But there's a long kick by Lamb, a torpedo that travelled a little bit further than Lee's expected.
52 seconds of play left in this third quarter, and that's exactly what Richmond did not want. Again, the margin is 21 points. There's the ruck jewels again. That was Jackson. Justin Pickering's been a very quiet player. That's holding the man. just over 40 seconds of play left in this quarter. Richmond need a goal before three-quarter time. This is McKellar over the top to Manton. Manton back to McKellar. Can they get a goal? Back to Manton. Manton from 65 metres out sets it up. They need someone to take a goal here. Philip Egan at the back. But the ball is fisted away by Murray Rance, who played a good solid game today in defence. And that point now makes the margin 20 points. 53 plays 73. 11-7 to 7-11. Guy McKenna about to bring it back into play.
Just 15 seconds left. Lewis marks near the boundary line at halfback. 20-point lead will be pretty handy going into the last quarter for the Eagles. A free kick to Turley. No, not paid. Ball out of play. And there is three-quarter time. A 20-point lead to the Eagles. They lead 11-7 to 7-11. That was a quarter. The Eagles won by just 2 points. They led by 18 at halftime and now lead by 20 points. In that quarter, the Eagles kicked 4 goals, 2, and Richmond kicked 3 goals, 6. So it was a disastrous quarter as far as accuracy was concerned for the Tigers. Jackson didn't add to his tally. He kicked 4 goals, all in the second quarter. Scott Watt has got a couple of goals in that quarter, and Sumich also has 2. And Richmond have struggled to find regular goal kickers. Hogg's their only multiple, and he's kicked 2. Egan went to full forward and got one within the space of about a minute. And I suppose you'd have to say that 20 points the difference, Richmond could still come back. But, well, since about the 10-minute mark of the second quarter, the Eagles have deserved this.
Yeah, I suppose on the scoreboard you could say Richmond are still a chance, but they're not playing well enough to get back into this match because they just have not got the players on the forward line. We criticised the Eagles' forward line in that first quarter. But ever since quarter time, Richmond's forward line has been non-existent. Egan now playing at full forward, Hogg out on the half forward line. Not getting a lot of drive around the packs, Richmond. And the Eagles finding a much more direct line towards goal, using the centre corridor much better. They're not going wide to the flanks where they wasted the ball so many times in that first quarter.
Final quarter about to get underway here soon. We'll be back with you in a moment.
They're giving Fitzroy a hiding now. Hawthorn. Hawthorn done their normal.
What's the score? I can't see the ball.
17-12 to 9-5.
Yeah. And they were level nearly at half time.
Yeah. Thank you,
Al. It was only about 4 points, wasn't it? At
yeah,
half-time.
They're about 9 goals in front.
Mm. Funnily enough, I still think Richmond can win this.
If they get a couple of quick goals, they'd be right in it. They're not out of it, are they?
No. Get underway. The Eagles leading by 20 points. So far the free kicks have favoured Richmond 33-13. Richmond win it out of the middle again. Poole number 23 fighting with Lewis. Lewis has had 19 possessions, 16 kicks and 3 hand passes. The leader for the Eagles is Mainwaring, 15 kicks and 7 handballs for 22 possessions. The leaders on the field, 23 possessions each to Lambert and McKellar, who've alternated on the ball for Richmond. So Richmond close enough, trailing by 20 points, but they'd have to turn it around. Although I suppose you could say that they destroyed a few chances in that third quarter by kicking, what was it, 3-6.
The ball's almost in the centre of the ground. There's a push in the back, and the first 5 minutes of this final quarter are vital as far as Richmond are concerned. Honeybun towards half forward. The mark not held by Geoff Hogg, has been moved out to centre half forward during that third quarter. There's Peter Wilson shuffling it away towards Peters. Wilson again diving on top of it. Good play by Wilson. Unfortunately, his hand pass has gone straight to Dean Turner. Turner to half forward for the Eagles. Sumich tempting the mark. Two men to beat, and he taps the ball over the line. Peter Sumich today has kicked two goals. One, a beautiful long raking left foot drop punt that travelled about 55 metres.
Honeybun and O'Connell goes Richmond's way. Hand pass goes astray to Knights. Is he good enough to get it yet? He does, to McKellar. Kick goes about 10 metres. Manton charged at it, went without it. Lambert, great play to get clear. And again, but Lewis chased well to get him. Off he goes to Poole, 45 metres out, and Poole goals for the Tigers.
As you said, Peter, that first 5 minutes of this last quarter, very vital to Richmond. The Eagles can either sneak away or Richmond can get back into the match. And it's very vital
that they win the ball out of the centre square. Honeybun, who's played a good game,
starting to get a couple of knockouts there and give Richmond the first opportunity to get the ball in the forward line. Poole playing across the half forward line where Richmond have really missed out, and Poole probably will do a few things there to help them lift in that area.
The Eagles now only lead by 14 points, but every time this has happened today since quarter time, the Eagles have been able to retaliate with another goal. But this time, it's Matthew Knights getting it towards half court. Here's Lambert. The lead is on. Egan. Yes. Now he's only 30 metres out directly in front. And if he kicks this, they will only be down by 8 points.
There's a lead by Egan, very wide open forward line. And Richmond doing it well out of the centre square, where it's very vital to win that contest.
Guy McKenna has played a great game, but he couldn't do much about that pass. Philip Egan, a chance to get Richmond within 8 points. He's kicked two goals already, and that's his third.
So Egan kicking that very good goal, bringing the ball into the forward line very quickly, Richmond. I think that's his second, Peter, but I think he's missed a couple that he should have kicked earlier on. He's kicked two goals, two and one out of bounds on the full. And Philip Egan, a good move by Bartlett, putting him at full forward, because he's a player who moves around a lot. And Hogg giving him a little bit of life on that, across that half forward line, along with Poole.
So Richmond making a game of it now. First two goals of the last quarter. Honeybun wins in the middle again. Richmond have dominated the ruck. Brennan's kick up to half forward, chopped off by Bauer. Bauer, a 50 metre kick back to half forward. Comes out to Poole, who kicked the Tigers first this quarter. Not sure where to go. Gets a run from Nuts. His left footer popped up in the air. Egan one out again. Not this time. Comes to the back. Rance has been a grand defender for the Eagles. Kicks out of defence. All Richmond on the wing. Straight back to Knights.
Philip Knights. Towards Peter Wilson. The short one is on. And he's found a man in Justin Pickering. I think I said Philip Knights. Matthew Knights, of course. Philip Knights, a Fitzroy player. Wilson, short one. Now Pickering will kick from 50 metres. This is Justin Pickering. Of course, his brother was knocked out early in the game with a hip and shoulder from Miles and has been taken to hospital. There's the kick. It's through.
Oh, a great comeback by Richmond. Justin Pickering has been very quiet. He's been well held. Had a spell on the bench earlier on. Back on the ground after half time. Found a bit of space there on the forward line. A good pass by Knights to Wilson. And Richmond full of running. Wilson, a quick pass on to Pickering, and a good kick for goal from Pickering from about 45 metres out. Richmond right back in this.
Two points the difference. Eagles lead. They need a goal now. They need it badly. Richmond have got a run on. Honeybun. Take it away by Waterman. A quick kick straight up in the air. Big punch away. Good time by Wilson. Here they come again. Trevor Poole. Egan on the lead. Out he comes. A beautiful forward play. Guy McKenna. No chance of cutting that one off. And lovely football by Richmond.
It's great play by the Tigers, winning the ball out of the centre square yet again. And Poole, as I said, has given the Tigers plenty of drive across that half-forward line. Egan on the end of the pass, but really the hard work done in the centre of the ground, winning it out from that bounce.
And a good style of forward play that by Richmond. Instead of just blazing away up forward, hoping someone will take a mark. Good coaching by Kevin Bartlett. Egan a chance to put Richmond in front by 4 points. Yes!
So another goal to the Tigers, which puts him in front. Egan kicks his second goal for the quarter, his third for the match. He's kicked 3 goals, 2 and 1 out of bounds on the full. And it was a great move by Kevin Bartlett, putting him at full forward because they weren't getting any drive across the half-forward line. Hogg playing out at centre-half forward or across the half-forward line. And really, they've got a couple of options there. And it's made all the difference to this Richmond side.
Well, Richmond trailed by 20 points at three-quarter time. They've kicked 4 goals in 5 minutes and have hit the front. And the crowd, who was asleep for most of the day, have really come to life now. Eagles up to the forward line. There's a good mark. Maybe a 50 to Sumich against Laffey, but the umpire coming in to mark. And so Sumich will be kicking for goal from just inside 50 metres. Peter Sumich, who kicked 2 goals in the second quarter. And if he can get this one, the Eagles are back in front. They're down by 4 points. It's a good-looking kick by Sumich. They're back in front all right.
It's a magnificent kick by Sumich. He's played well on the forward line. Kicked 2 goals in the second quarter. And now 1 in the last quarter, which has put the Eagles back in front. A very handy goal, but he is a magnificent kick of the football. Takes a strong grab. There he is, kicking from about 45 metres. Over the ball, plenty of air. And kicked out a good 60 metres.
Well, what a game we have on our hands now. 2 points the difference. West Coast in front. Craig Turley out of the centre towards half-forward. Over the back is the danger man, Lewis. Taken away by Bauer. Bauer out towards centre wing. This is Michael Thompson. A long hand pass. Dustin Pickering. Peter Wilson. Allan McKellar. He's caught. That's holding the ball. Oh! Dwayne Lamb. Punched away. Tony Free has taken the ball at half-back. A hand pass to Michael Thompson. Thompson from centre wing. The long kick towards half-forward. The big flyers by Manton. Didn't quite hold it long enough. Tipped away by Lamb. Over to Rance. And Murray Rance has gone for the safety of the boundary line, has he? No. Waters. Now it was over the line. So it'll be a throw-in on centre wing. Gee, was that not holding the ball or what?
No, that was a magnificent tackle by Johnny Worsfold and should have been rewarded.
Eagles by 2 points and we have 18 minutes left in the match. Honeybun wins another tap. It goes to Poole. He threw the ball away. The umpire says play on. Comes to Rance. Wilson there with him. Sock it out of his hands and the ball eventually out of bounds. Well, they've lifted the tempo remarkably for this final quarter and the crowd starting to warm the lungs as well. Richmond led by 19 points at quarter time. But the Eagles kicked 7-1 in the second quarter to lead by 18 at half time and then 20 points at three quarter time. Now their lead is just 2 points. Scott eventually. Pike. Beautiful kick to Sumich. But Manton did well to get back there on him. Jackson back to Sumich. Kick smothered by Lees and the ball goes out of bounds alongside the behind post.
2 points the difference. West Coast in front. Peter Sumich on screen. Has kicked 3. Jackson's kicked 4. And they've been pretty good forwards. Jackson mostly in one quarter, of course. The second is Jackson doing the ruck work. Over the back was Wilson. Guy McKenna's been moved to the forward line. Back it comes to Waters from Dean Turner. Waters on the left foot. He's put it through.
Good play, good forward line play there by the Eagles. Waters kicking his third. And very handy goal for the West Coast Eagles. Been under a lot of pressure here from Richmond at the start of this last quarter. Waters, presence of mind to steady, have a balk around to the Richmond player, and a good kick on the left foot.
And a good move by John Todd to put McKenna down there with his skill. They've got Miles playing at fullback now on Philip Egan.
And the rain's starting to fall. And I think it's the first time we've had rain on a match day in Melbourne this year. Here's Mainwaring. Puts out the hand pass wide. Wilson does well. But the soccer off the ground gains 20 metres. McKenna's hand pass a bit slick for Lewis. Ball might be a bit greasy. Thompson. Good use of his body, but Lewis comes in to force the ball up at half forward for the Eagles. It's 8 points the difference. The West Coast in front, 13-7 to 11 goals, 11. A lot of players around this ball up. Honeybun wins another one. Kick smothered, comes to Mainwaring, his hand passes wild. Then he was tackled high, free kick against Bauer to Mainwaring.
Chris Mainwaring at half forward. A handy lead, that's 8 points. He's gone backwards to Worsfold. 16 kicks to Chris Mainwaring. Worsfold. Oh, Sumich was up very, very early. Off the ground by Pike, and it sneaks through for a behind. So they go 1 point further in front, the Eagles. They've come back well because Richmond really had a run on there for a moment. But they're not out of the woods yet because they only lead by 9 points, the West Coast Eagles.
Lees kicks in and the mark accepted by Morris. Test of character for both teams now. Kicked by Morris, marked by Justin Pickering. Halfback flank for the Tigers. Centering kick. Laffey moved up the ground, screams down to take the mark. Richmond working towards the outer side. Wilson fumbles. Waitman's had a pretty quiet day back after injury. Gets the hand pass away this time well to Lambert. Puts it wide, that's great play. The hand pass further by Peters. Off to Knights. He goes to an unmarked player. Goal coming up to Hogg.
Great teaming there by Richmond, running the ball into the forward line. And a series of hand passes set that goal up. They did overuse the handball in that first half, but on that occasion were able to use the handball to their advantage, bringing it down to the forward line, ending up with Hogg. And Geoff Hogg, who hasn't had a brilliant day on the forward line, that kicks his third goal. And more importantly, Richmond are right back in this match.
Well, what a game we have on our hands now. 3 points of difference, but the West Coast are still in front as Craig Turley. No, it wasn't. It was Mainwaring. In fact, it was Turley. The quick kick down towards half four. This is Chris Lewis. Could have picked it up. He tried to kick it off the ground. There's Peter Sumich. Back to Lewis. And the umpire said that that was what?
It wasn't a hand pass. He threw it up with one hand.
And then threw it up, then hit it. So deemed a throw.
Richmond player down injured here. Bauer. Free kick taken by Manton to centre wing. Big climb by Poole, but couldn't come down with the mark. Peters, like the look of him today. And the pass is good to half forward for Hogg. Too far out to score. Two kicks to goal from there. Egan leads. He's got it again. Philip Egan, centering kick is good. Right in front of goal, the mark to Trevor Poole. And a straight kick will put the Tigers back in front.
Well, that was great play by Philip Egan. There's Bauer. Look at Egan with the play there. He didn't have a look at the goals. He saw a chance to centre the ball, and good position played by Poole.
Courageous mark by Poole too, because there was trouble coming for him. He kicked a goal earlier in this quarter. Bauer going to the bench, so Richmond are going to finish with 18 fit players. Michael Pickering already in hospital. Trevor Poole to put the Tigers in front. They lead by 3 points.
And Poole kicks his second for the quarter. He's been a handy player since he came on for the Tigers across that half forward line. There's Bauer, who's off the ground. Lounder back on the ground. Didn't have a touch in that first half. Big Richard Lounder. There's a lead up. Good play by Egan. Great use of the body to take that mark over Miles. Saw the opportunity to get the pass off. The centering pass. Good courageous mark there by Poole as well.
There's John Todd. Looks a very worried man now. 3 points of difference. Tigers in front. And they come back West Coast. Phil Scott against David Honeybun. Honeybun gets it. Mainwaring's there. And Waterman. Rance tries to kick it off the ground, but here's Leffy. Peter Wilson from 55 metres, the long raking kick. Lounder in front. Shoved away there by the West Coast Eagles fullback and Andrew Lockyer, and he forces it over the line for a point. The difference now on the scoreboard is 4 points.
Short pass into play to Worsfold. We've got 12 and a half minutes remaining in the match. Worsfold's kick drops a bit short. Scott goes back to him. Now he goes longer to centre wing. Punch out by Morris is good. Tigers fans are pretty pleased to see the way some of these youngsters are going. Morris is just 20. Peter's 19. Four points the difference with Richmond in front. Lounder has dominated the hitouts all day. Waters. Wide he goes to Waterman. Up to half forward. Ball's thumped out but doesn't go out. Mainwaring fumbles it out. Well, it's Turley and we'll have a throw in.
Well, it's halfway between centre wing and half forward for the Eagles. Long, long way out from goal. But they do trail by 4 points. They wouldn't want to let Richmond get the next goal, I wouldn't think. Here's Dwayne Lamb with a quick kick towards the forward pocket. A race for the ball. Guy McKenna, oh, he's got it. Cleverly done. Meant to give it to Peter Sumich, but it was smothered off his hands and over the line. But further around, it's a free kick. The umpire said deliberate. Rowan saw something there and he said it's a free kick to Guy McKenna. Everyone's a little bit mystified. He's at the 50 metre mark. His skill will be handy in this final quarter down there on the forward line. Now, he'll have to kick from 55 metres and set it up for someone to take a big mark. At the back is O'Connell, the flyer. Couldn't take it. Here's Craig Lambert. Sprints away onto the left foot and brings it wide. Looking out there for Philip Knights. Matthew Knights, I should say. And the little Rover's got it at halfback.
Eldon not in possession. Coming up for his 15th kick. Knights. Under 11 minutes remaining in the game. Short of centre wing. Poole with the sit. And a climb Lamarck! Running off him is Justin Pickering. The kick to half forward to Hogg. Oh, he's put one down that he should have taken. Rance gets the hand pass back to Worsfold. Short pass to Waters is good.
Waters wants to play on. Now, has he got a loose man? Yes, he has. He gives it wide. This is Turley. Turley going long. That's the way to play it. Oh, beautiful pass. Now, Bernie Quinlan. We've seen the kicking ability of Sumich today. Can he boot this one?
Oh, I think he will make the distance. He will be kicking from just on the 50 metre or just outside from about probably 52 metres. He kicks the ball a long distance, does Peter Sumich.
Well, he's got the chance to put the Eagles 2 points in front with just under 10 minutes of play left. Peter Sumich on that left foot. A long raking kick. It floats. It's missed. Just came across the face of goal and you can tell by the elation behind the goals. They're all Richmond down there. Difference now is 3 points. What a game.
Well, the rain didn't last very long, but the surface might be a little bit greasy. Kick in by Morris. Good kick. And Madden couldn't come down with the mark. Pike, well played. He backed out of him. A centering kick. Big chance here for the Eagles. Comes to the front. Lewis beats a tackle. Slips to ground though. Paddles for Jackson. Sumich off the ground. Missed. Ooh, that was so close. And the scores are close as well. 2 points the difference.
Well, this is anyone's game. And great to see a game finishing like this. We weren't sure during the day. First, early it looked all Richmond, then it looked all Eagles. And what a great last quarter we're seeing as we see Manton towards half back. Oh, the mark dropped by Mainwaring, but Wurstfeld's there to lend a hand. Back comes John Wurstfeld, nearly loses his shorts, and he puts the ball out of bounds on the full.
Great play by Trevor Poole.
Well, the free kick to Allan McKellar. McKellar's gone to centre wing. Oh, setting himself, he's very good overhead, Wayne Peters, as he takes a good mark.
Peters plays on quickly. Hogg's on the 50. Good mark this time. Well, he dropped a bad one a couple of minutes ago. That was more difficult, but he held onto the wet ball. 13th kick for Geoffrey Hogg. Don't know whether he could make the distance from wide out and outside the 50. He's gone for everything and has kicked a point. Well, it's 3 points the margin, but still the Eagles within a kick.
91 plays 88. The Richmond cheer squad in full voice. Not many Eagles supporters here. Lockyer has gone short. He's found Chris Waterman. Waterman from half back. Brings it right around the wing. Oh, a bit of pushing and shoving there, but the mark has been taken by Michael Thompson. Thompson towards half forward. Over the back is Big Lounder. Let's see what Wurstfeld can do. He's got it. When the going gets tough, John Wurstfeld is always out there and playing well. And he puts it towards the line and over the line at half forward for Richmond.
7.5 minutes remaining. Hutton about to come back on the ground for the Eagles. He was replaced by Waterman earlier this quarter. Comes to Waterman. Had plenty of time that time. Weightman climbs but can't take the mark. Well done. Knocking the ball up the ground. Mainwaring goes to ground. It's pretty desperate in there now. The umpire calls for it and is going to ball it up. If anything, the Tigers have a slight breeze in this final term, but it really hasn't had any effect on the game. And Richmond have their noses in front by 3 points.
Phil Scott against Michael Laffey. Justin Pickering. Back to Weightman. Weightman runs into a brick wall. He's caught. Gets in the hand pass. Chris Mainwaring crashes his way through. Onto the left foot. Beautiful play to O'Connell. Oh, good vision that by Mainwaring. O'Connell kicks long. Sumich at the back. Can't take the mark, but the umpire said he pushed Brendan Bauer in the back. Peter Sumich didn't think so.
Yeah, they have been flogged in the free kicks department. Is Peters fumbling. Lewis paddles up the ground. Pike grabbed by three. Keeps going. Oh, well played by Pike. Well, he's now surrounded by Richmond players. In heaps of bother. Hutton just off the boundary, off the interchange bench. And a great smother by Bauer sees the ball out.
Tremendous play, Brendan Bauer. Then he was injured. Pike with terrific skills by Pike. But we're seeing everything at the moment. It's tapped down. Hutton. It's at half forward. Here's Dean Turner. Drops it. And the umpire said it was held to him. And it'll be another bounce at that 50-metre line. We have just under 6 minutes of play left in the game. Rowan Saw is about to bounce it. The Eagles trail by 3 points. There's Lambert. And Hutton. Now it's free. Dragged to the ground. Punched away back towards the half forward line. This is Honeybun giving it to Wilson. Wilson onto the left. Two on one. Lewis. Oh, beautiful use of the body, Lewis. Lewis at half forward, about 70 metres out from goal.
5.5 minutes left. Turner marks on the 50. Gets round onto his right boot. Goes long to the goal square. Jackson's there. Outnumbered 2-1. Ball comes back to the goal square and Manton rushes a behind. Which gets the Eagles within 2 points. I think it was the right thing to do there.
Ooh, but in the final analysis it might be costly.
Well, 2 points the difference. Peter Wilson. Next goal could easily win this game. Laffey a good lead. Wilson finds him at half back. Michael Laffey or Lewis is waiting at the back to try and get the loose ball here. It's a bit of shepherding going on there. Oh, Lamb beautifully to Waters. Good play by Dwayne Lamb. Scott Waters runs onto the left. Goes wide. No mark to the Eagles. That was Sumich trying to take it. Brendan Bauer, well done. Bauer onto the left foot's got a loose man out wide in Trevor Poole. He can run 70 metres if he wants to. Poole, the half forward Lewis sets himself in front. He's got help down there from Brennan. And Brennan, the umpire said, has taken the mark.
Under 4.5 minutes left.
Brennan comes across to centre half back. Turner drops the mark, thumps it up the ground. Turley deflects it, puts straight to the path of Laffey. Laffey gets the hand pass away, did well there. Poor old kick off. Peters is good enough though. Gee, is great contest going all over the park here. Free kick now to Richmond, to Justin Pickering. Can the Eagles get up? Who'll ever forget that heartbreaker in the elimination final last year when Murray Renstedt could have won the game against Melbourne? And in fact, this is only the second time they played a day match at VFL Park in their history, the Eagles, and they might go down by a kick for the second time. Michael Thompson. Egan. Now it's Wilson, and he's got it inside 50, Peter Wilson.
Very poor defence there by the West Coast Eagles. 17 kicks coming up for Peter Wilson. He's been a very busy player. There's a pass from Thompson. But Wilson able to find a lot of space there to move into, and not an Eagles player putting any pressure on.
Well, 2 points the difference. This could make or break this game, because we have 3 minutes and 10 seconds of play left. If he kicks it, the Tigers will lead by 8 points, and it'll be very hard for the Eagles with the ground now a little bit slippery. Peter Wilson, 45 metres out, almost directly in front, kicks, and I think he might have missed. Oh, how costly will that be, Bernie Quinlan?
Oh, yes, that was a vital kick for goal from Wilson. Would have made it very difficult for the Eagles to get back in the match had he kicked that one.
Well, 3 points the difference. It should come up the centre of the ground, I reckon, with 2 minutes and 44 seconds of play left in this match. Andrew Lockyer, Hutton at the back is the big flyer. Can't take the mark. Lambert at the base of the back. Hutton goes in. He's caught. Handball away. In went Trevor Poole. Grabbed by Honeybun. A quick kick up the side of the boot. Lambert tries to keep it in play but can't do so. The ball at half court for the Tigers with 2 minutes and 25 seconds of play left.
Laffey in ruck. Won by the Eagles. It comes to Mainwaring. Off to Turner. Might be the Eagles' last chance. Running onto this is O'Connell. Might be a goal coming up. O'Connell may be one step too many. Gets the kick away. And a defensive mark to Manton. Probably the first he's taken all day.
Uncontested, Drew.
Out to half-back flank. Honeybun can't mark. Still a chance for the Eagles, though. They're on the 50. Picked up by Waters. Off to Turner. A goal could win the game. He's at the post.
Oh, Dean Turner, very experienced player. Played a lot of football over here and not a difficult shot from about 35 metres out.
2 points the difference. Richmond in front. Time clock ticking down. 1 minute and 35 seconds of play left. Peter Wilson, can he get there? He can. He's marked at half back for Richmond. What a vital, couple of vital misses in this last quarter. Peter Wilson has had a number of kicks. In fact, he's had 18 kicks for the day. A good effort by that player. Getting towards the 1 minute mark. 2 points the difference. The Tigers in front. Laughing against Scott. Who'll get it from this ruck duel? Trevor Poole lying over the ball. Phil Scott trying to get boot the ball. Lambert is there. Hand pass over the top to Weightman. Oh, he's nearly unloaded. Back to Rance, and Rance brings it around centre wing.
Defensive mark taken by Morris. Under a minute left and Richmond lead by 2 points. Kick by Morris. Laffey's played a pretty good last quarter and Trevor Poole's had an outstanding one. Here's Lambert and the Tigers slowing things down on centre wing. The Eagles need the ball and they're a long way from goal. Lambert's kick to half forward. Egan climbs into the pack. Justin Pickering pleased to see the ball out of play. 26 seconds remaining and Richmond lead 92-90. Well, Richmond's form has fluctuated this season and this game has fluctuated from quarter to quarter. Waterman gets a hand pass out. Weightman charges at the ball and dives at it. And it might be enough to win the game for Richmond. There's 3 seconds left. The Tigers are going to get up. So it's happened to the Eagles again at VFL Park in the daytime. It happened in the elimination final last year. and they bowed out today by just 2 points, 13-14 Richmond, 13 goals 12 the West Coast Eagles.
That ended up all right, didn't it? Better than I thought, mate.
Righto.
Who are you barracking for in there?
Okay. We've got about 2 minutes, boys.
That didn't do all right. You start off, Ben.
No, no highlights.
Hey?
No highlights.
We've had another great game.
Yeah.
I thought this would be close though today.
Great.
Poor. I didn't know who to pick. I was at Richmond, actually.
Did you pick them?
Yeah. I think we both...
We both picked them, didn't we? At the start?
Yeah, the start of the game.
Yeah.
But during the game, I thought Eagles were certainties.
They're both very ordinary sides.
Shock!
I thought them were given for Troy, I didn't.
Yeah, 10 goals. 10. You know what Geelong's picked?
33 though, roughly.
Looks like they're
no good. No.
A remarkable last quarter, and Richmond hung on to win by 2 points, 13-14 to 13 goals 12, after the Eagles had led by 20 points at three-quarter time, and at one stage the Eagles led by 27 points 7 minutes into the third quarter. For the Eagles, Jackson kicked four goals all in the second quarter. Waters came off the bench to kick three goals, and Sumich also kicked three goals. But Richmond, well, their goals were spread around. Hogg finished with three, Poole got two in the last quarter, and Egan kicked three after being moved to full forward. So once again, the Eagles have missed out by a kick here at VFL Park, and I suppose as much as we've talked about Renstead's miss last year in the elimination final, we might talk about Dean Turner hitting the post here today.
Yes, it wasn't a difficult shot, was it, Drew? It was only 35 metres out on the run, no pressure being applied, and that was a kick that cost them the match. But a win that was full of merit to Richmond, because in that last quarter they were 20 points down at three-quarter time. They were really pushing it in the last quarter to get back into the match. They did well because they got the ball out of the centre. Their running players came into the game. Egan was playing at full forward, a good move by Kevin Bartlett to put him at full forward and bring Hogg out from full forward to centre half forward. And Richmond really got back into the game because they're a gutsy side. They never stop, do they, Peter? They keep on going all the time, and you know they're going to give 100 minutes.
They do. They looked a different combination that last quarter. I agree with you, Bernie. The move was Egan to full forward. Just gave them that bit of zip around the forward line and put McKenna off balance, who was killing him on the back line. And of course, Geoff Hogg was a good player when he went out. Peter Wilson battled hard all day and did some dynamic things, but a good win and a good game overall. We've seen some great football this year, and I think football, Drew, is getting better as the years go on.
Absolutely. And aren't the Eagles at the moment deficient in the ruck, with Laurie Keane's career at the crossroads perhaps, and well, Honeybun just got his hands to everything.
Yeah. No, I think they also, I think their forwards, I agree with that, and I'm still not convinced about their forward setup. They really need a real top class forward.
Okay, well, that's the story here from VFL Park. Once again, an unfruitful trip for the Eagles to Melbourne and certainly to VFL Park, going down to Richmond by 2 points. Hope you've enjoyed the telecast. Well, I suppose there's no way they could have enjoyed the telecast. They're throwing bricks at the set. Hawthorn, 25 again.
Oh, look at everyone.
That's a hiding, isn't it?
That's a hiding. Even the last quarter, they've kicked eight.
Yeah. That's 13 goals. Look at that.
Look at Geelong and St Kilda. Look how many goals.
That's a progress score.
Oh, no. Has that beat your record?
No, no.
36-22.
11 points.
Oh, that's the close.
What's 11 points?
That's a big win, isn't it?
That's a huge win against Fitzroy, that, isn't it?
Mm.
I bet you Dunstall's kicked a few there.
What do you reckon?
Four there are good. So they're premiers. Premiers, don't worry about
Donald.
The Hawks have kicked 17 after half-time, 2 weeks in a row.
Well, how good are they? And you know what Collingwood did? Faded in the last quarter. Your Footscray were coming home.
Were they?
Fitzroy kicked 5 in the last half.
So
17-5 in the last half.
They are the greatest certainties of all time, I reckon. I really believe that.
Barring injury.
Barring injury, yeah, that's the only thing.